Well, whatever. We'll just win them all regardless, apparently.
Yeah, it's a little easy at this point. Everybody beats Keeper all the time. You said you have a 25% chance of winning a Keeper run.
I think that that's actually fair. I think a 25% chance of winning the Keeper run is sensible.
That's very strong
you
for me.
You only need, like, Nun's Habit, AAA Battery, 9 Volt, or Petrified Poop, or Swallowed Penny. Like, you just need to go for those, and then you got it. And even if you don't get them, there's probably, like, a 10% chance you get it.
I guess. I don't know. I never found it to be that simplistic. But anyway, here's the seed.
Okay.
Eden RM8X.
RM8X.
CF2Z.
CF2Z. What is Z in the military alphabet?
Zeta.
Is it really like Catherine Zeta-Jones, the woman with with the vagina that gave Michael Douglas
That's exactly right.
Esophageal cancer?
I'm really surprised we went into that with such detail, honestly. That doesn't seem like a topic that 2 years ago Northern Lion would have embraced.
I guess it's like apparently it's Zulu, by the way. I mean, it is a little bit gross, I guess. Like, it's a little contentious and like, vulgar. But at the same time, I love exploring the notion that at some point, Michael A.L. Fox had to answer for his crimes of saying that his wife's vagina gave him cancer.
You just said Michael A.L. Fox.
And by Michael A.L. Fox, Michael Douglas. If Michael Douglas is listening, Michael A.L. Fox totally did not sleep with Catherine Zeta-Jones. Definitely not at a New Year's Eve party in Toronto in 1999 when he was 11 years old and Entrapment had just come out. Prime CZJ time, if you know what I mean.
I'm just saying those lasers get the juices flowing.
She dips beneath them. On numerous occasions.
When she dips, I dip. We dip.
Just like this. How many times have we been through this bit? I've still, like, never heard this song.
I put your hands up on this bit.
I only know the one that goes...
Bit, we bit.
What's the one that goes, when I move, you move, just like this? I know that one. When I move, you move, just like this.
No, I don't know that one.
You don't know that one?
I know the other one that I was just doing.
I don't know that one. I've never heard that one.
They're all like dance songs from the 90s.
What's your favorite 90s, like, Hathaway era dance track?
What was that first word you just said?
Hathaway? They sang What Is Love.
So, like, a thing with a consistent kick drum or drum track.
Yeah, like an electronic drum track that came out between, like, 1991 and 1996.
That would have to be... I'm too sexy.
I think that does count. For some reason, I had ascended that to a higher plane. Like, that's actually like a one-hit wonder, which is, strangely enough, above that category. I think for me, it's... Do you know the one that goes, Saturday night, I got the feeling getting hot, pretty baby.
No, I never heard that
one. You don't know Saturday Night?
I know Saturday Night Fever.
That's a different thing.
Is anyone getting a fever?
I mean, you probably get a fever if you, like, listen to it when you're sick. But it's not because of the song. It's just because, you know.
You just feel like shit.
Yeah, you're just like,
you don't like that
ill.
Song.
OMG, that song is so good. It's so good. I hate that song. That's different.
Those are almost opposite reaction.
That's different people saying that, I should point out. Okay. Anything by the Venga Boys? The Venga Boys only hit it big in, like, 1998. That's like, I put that in like the pop era as opposed to like the weird, like, electronic music has hit the forefront. Mm-hmm. So now we can have, like, you know, uh-huh, yeah, wanna be my lover. You know that one?
You know that whistle that they put in some of those songs?
Okay, can you do an approximation of it?
It's not a human whistle, it's the sound of an actual whistle.
Okay, like...
It's like a specific whistle they use for dance songs.
Like the one that Terry Crews uses in, I forget what show it is. It might be Brooklyn Nine-Nine when he's dancing around doing the rave.
Maybe. It's got a real name. I'm sure that Chad will know it.
It's the gym teacher whistle? James Nastics?
Yeah, but it's not a slide whistle. It is like the gym teacher whistle. And I think you can kind of separate dance music into a pre and post era of that sound. Because that whistle just goes away in the early 2000s forever, I think.
Yeah, now we got the millennial. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa,
And auto-tune bullshit.
Dude, someone totally reminded me of a song that was on, like, one of the Jock Jams CDs I had. No Limit. You know that one? No limit. Oh, reach for the sky.
I've probably heard it once or twice.
No river too deep. No mountain too high. Lella so Luna. Inspirational. Thank you. It always makes me want to get up and not dance, but, like, enroll in a college, I was thinking. Like, achieve my dreams.
Also, the idea of the word jock jams just sounds like a bad idea by itself. I mean, people refer to people's dicks as a jock for some reason. I don't really understand.
Right, that's correct.
Your jock strap holds it in. But, like, you don't want to jam up your jock.
They're all, like, I don't know why all sports is about dicks. It's always about dicks. You got cups,
really
jocks. If you play them, you're a jock. You wear a jock.
There's jockeys who wear jocks.
Jockeys wear jocks. You can get jock itch.
Jocks.
I've had jock itch. I wouldn't recommend it.
This is when your balls itch, right?
It's a fungal infection in your scrotal area, yes.
I didn't know it was like anything. I thought it was just like your balls are sweaty.
I think I told this story, but like I was in hockey school over spring break because I grew up in Canada.
You went to school for hockey?
Well, don't you have like... Because you call it, like, you know, football camp or something like that, where you go...
Oh, it's like a training thing. Okay.
Yeah, it's like spring break, and they're like, hey, we're going to, you know, for the next week, you're in hockey school, so we're going to teach you how to, like, skate backwards and stop and stuff like that.
That's pretty sweet.
And, you know, it's like a couple $100, and it gives
you, like...
Did you
like it?
No, I hated it, actually. After, like, 3 days, I quit because I actually had a medical emergency, and it was... well, not emergency, but it was jock itch. It was because I didn't realize that, you know, in hockey, you're wearing, like, a ton of equipment, right?
Yeah, you get real sweaty in there.
You get real sweaty. You got hockey pants that you put on. I didn't realize you're just supposed to put those on over your underwear. I thought you put them on. I thought you put them on over your pants. So I was wearing like actual jeans or like, you know, track pants or something like that, and then putting all of my hockey equipment on top of my existing clothes. And then it got real sweaty down there. I got an infection. I had to stop. I had to quit hockey school. Also, I kind of hated it, so it was fine, but...
It's ironic because it's such a... Like, you're playing on ice, but you're sweating.
Oh, it gets real hot out there, man.
The coldness, like, has nothing to do with the heat that's building up under the clothes. It's just funny.
It may have also been that, you know, locker room wasn't cleaned as often as it should be. I don't know.
Well, like, you weren't, like, rubbing your junk down in, like, the edge of the wall, right?
Well, I did whatever coach told me to do.
Yeah, I guess that's fair. You don't want to piss the coach off.
Jock itch is a get-out-of-jail-free card. Exactly. It's the perfect crime. I was actually 7. So, people were like, why didn't you clean your balls more often? I didn't even know that I had balls back then, okay? I didn't even know. I was like, everybody's got these, right?
I think your T-count knew it was too high for your own good before you even knew what a T-count was.
Exactly. I mean, that's pretty much it. Like,
that's a fun story.
That's the end of that story.
That's the first and last time that I want to hear about your balls itching.
Yeah, that's fair. It's a bummer, though, because it's like, you know, playing hockey is, like, really expensive. You gotta buy like all this equipment. Yeah, it can be like, especially if you're a goalie, which I wasn't, but you could pay like several $100 just to get equipment that your kid's gonna like grow out of in a year or two, right?
Yeah, and break probably.
And then you go to like hockey school, and tuition for that was like a few $100 back in the mid '90s, so it's pretty expensive. And then, you know, day three, your kid's like, I got, you know, ringworm on my balls. Ah, shit.
Oh no.
Well, that's a bummer. There goes that $6 million contract. Thanks a lot, Louis Erickson.
There goes my kids' balls. No grandkids here.
No grandkids. He got the jock itch.
I thought you could just get a pair of skates and like an old stick, and that was gonna run you like $50, and you'd be good.
No way, dude. That's like maybe in like the 1930s. Now it's
I'm
like
thinking of like old school sandlot style baseball version of hockey,
yeah.
Which is not really, I guess, a thing.
No, now it's like, you know, you gotta... Alexander Ovechkin has this stick, and he scored 50 goals, so my 2-year-old son has to have that stick as well.
The absurdity, like, when I was growing up, it was all about skateboarding, and
everybody
had to make a big fuss about how much they knew about skateboarding, and how these bearings were the good ones because of this reason, and if you have these bearings, which no one can see or tell the difference between...
Yeah.
Then you're a shitty skateboarder.
Did you guys have West 49 in America?
No.
Okay, West 49 is like a skateboarding apparel, but also skate shop chain in Canada. Oh,
that, I wouldn't have had it here anyway.
They were bumping up until, like, from the year, like, 1998 until maybe, like, 2006, they were bumping. I don't think I've ever seen one in the past decade or so.
Oh,
but West 69 is also a great name. But then, yeah, I lived, like, in the super, like, blue-collar comedy belt of Canada. Uh-huh. And then my neighbor spent, like, $300 on a skateboard because he liked Tony Hawk's Pro Skater.
And yeah, that's why we all did it, honestly.
The road outside of his house was gravel, and his driveway was gravel. So he would, like, take this $300 skateboard onto his gravel driveway and be like, check it out, I can sort of ollie.
I can almost kickflip.
Yeah, like, you don't really land because the gravel is not steady ground, you know? It kind of, like, moves and shifts when you land on it. So it was probably, like, one of the worst purchasing decisions I've ever seen in my entire life. But that was, kids these days won't understand the power that Tony Hawk's Pro Skater had on our generation.
They never will.
It's like, you got it. First, and also, it gave you really unrealistic expectations. You expect to be, like, first time I step on a skateboard, I should at least be able to land a kickflip.
Yeah, that's only 100 points.
It's just left and square. How hard could it be? And I probably spent in my whole life, I probably spent like 100 hours on a skateboard. I don't think I've ever landed anything more than an ollie that was like 2 inches off the ground.
I came really close to a kickflip once, but also one foot landed back on the board, the other one smashed the board into my ankle.
Oh, yeah, that's the word. I can feel your pain right now.
I'm over it now.
Someone in chat told me there's two West 49s at Metrotown. Are you fucking... Wow. I gotta go there for, like... Metrotown, I don't mean to brag. It's in Burnaby, which is the next city east of Vancouver, and it's the third largest mall in Canada. So, you know, we're not sweating it. But
you got like an Orange Julius in there?
Oh, there's probably like four Orange Juliuses in Metrotown.
That's awesome.
I've been to one of them. I'll vouch for one of them. It was like probably one of the top three $5 orange juices I've ever had. I gotta go to West 49 for like nostalgia's sake.
There's I can't let you get off the topic of this driveway thing, though, because it brought back a story for me. And the story is very simple, but, like, what's up with dads thinking that gravel is as good as cement for all activities?
I always thought it was, like, gravel was, like, that was, like, the default state of a driveway. And then if you got, like, a nice bonus from work for that, like, Christmas or something, then you'd be like, okay, we're paving the driveway.
That actually is probably the story that most have spun. But I think what it ends up being is it's sort of like a long, drawn-out con.
Yeah.
Right? When you're a little kid, they're like, hey, don't worry about it. We got a gravel driveway. Give this a couple of years. It's going to harden up like cement. And you're going to be playing basketball, and everything's going to be amazing. And the kids with the cement driveways, don't even worry about it. They'll be coming here.
I mean, paved driveway was like, it was an actual currency when you were a kid.
Yeah, it really was.
If you wanted to like rollerblade or play like road hockey or something like that, you can't do that shit on gravel.
I'm just saying the reality sets in when you turn 14 and it's like, all right, this is year six of the gravel driveway still being gravel. And, you know, it's not cement still. I'm going to get a skateboard and pretend it's cement for a while.
It's weird because I have like exactly the same story. It's like I lived in this house with a gravel driveway for like, might have been like, I guess it was 7 years I lived in this house with a gravel driveway. So from like age 7 until age 15, and every summer they'd be like, think of this is going to be the summer where we get the driveway paved. And I was like, oh, thank God. I've got this like, you know, like every kid, I have this basketball net out there.
Yep.
But it's on gravel, so it's like 5 degrees askew, and then when I go to gym class,
every time you dribble, it shoots off.
Like, well, I go to gym class, and I'm like, why are all my shots missing by like, you know, two centimeters? It's because I've been practicing with like basically a bad pair of glasses on. Like the laws of physics apply differently on my paved driveway or on my gravel driveway. And then I just moved. And I moved to a place with a paved driveway, but then I was like 16, and I was like, I don't want
to
go outside.
Oh, you're too old to appreciate it properly at that point. That sucks. Clams. You missed out on the prime years.
Clams and Mr. Snurbed. Thank you. Now, it's true, though. Like, if you're, like, between the age of, like, 7 and 14, that's prime driveway being paved ages.
I'm just thinking, like, my dad built me this fucking grind slide rail.
He bailed you on like a skateboard rail.
No, let me explain, because that sounds way overly grandiose. It was two planks with another plank on top of it.
Okay, yeah.
Like a long plank.
I understand.
And the idea was I was supposed to skate up to it on the gravel driveway and then grind on it. And I remember I had all my friends over, and they were all taking attempts to try and skate on this thing. And none of them could get any speed because it's a gravel driveway, but they're all trying anyway.
Yeah, you can't maintain any speed.
It's the most pathetic shit of all time.
And the worst thing is, like, if you take a spill on, like, a paved driveway, it's going to hurt. Yeah. You know, it's not going to feel nice.
Yeah, this is shrapnel, though.
Yeah, when you fall... I don't know if people know this, if you've never experienced a gravel driveway, but when you take a fall on a gravel driveway, you get, like, rocks embedded in your skin. And you go
in... Sometimes they don't come out for a couple days. You gotta dig them out.
You gotta go inside and be like, okay, now's... Mom, can you get, like, a knife? Because I have to cut the rocks out of my skin.
Mom, can you help me shear some of the flesh off my elbow? Got too much flesh, too many rocks.
Man, kids these days, they won't understand, like... I know I recognize the idiocy of saying kids these days, but I'm mostly just telling a joke. But I got a snowboard, like a really, really shitty snowboard. Because it snows in Canada, like, well, at least where I lived, it snowed like 4 or 5 months out of the year, right? So I was like, cool, I have this snowboard. But then there was only like a 3 foot high hill in my yard, so I would like go out and put on the snowboard, get like all my winter gear on, it'd take like 10 minutes... And I go take my snowboard to the top of this 3 foot hill, lean forward, slide until the end of the hill, which was approximately, I don't know, like 0.2 seconds, walk back up to the top of the hill, just do that for like 3 hours.
You had to take off your bindings at the bottom too.
Again,
every time,
then you just like walk up. Oh man.
That's, you know, it's a different era. I don't think kids would bother with that shit anymore. They're like, you know, we're just gonna, like, go play Call of Duty.
You got the Pokemans now and the... All that stuff. All your...
Kids still do bother with that shit, though.
You got your Pokemons and your Donald Trumps and your...
I do have a lot of those.
Tinders. Kids these days don't have time for...
Kids and Tinder. Kinder?
They should I snowboard or should I just keep browsing Kinder?
They end up with a Kinder surprise.
I don't know if I would say that.
You end up talking to Anthony Weiner on your messages.
Yo, speaking of the subjects of documentaries that are remarkably frank and also haunting, have you ever seen the movie Grizzly Man?
No, I don't think so. What's that about?
Okay, so Grizzly Man is from documentarian Werner Herzog. He's also done...
Yeah.
Do you know Werner Herzog?
I know the name, yeah.
Okay, he's an actor slash director. He's done a lot of documentaries like, you know, Encounters at the End of the World that is about, like, life in Antarctica. This one's about this guy, Timothy Treadwell. He's got sort of like an Into the Wild sort of situation.
That's a great name
for Timothy Treadwell? It is an assumed name. But basically, is this guy, he was kind of a misfit and he didn't fit in with, you know, the world of the humans. So every summer he would go to Alaska and he'd live with the bears. And he would film himself living with the bears, and it was touching, you know? He had, like, a lot of, like, sensitivity and a lot of, like, genuine love towards these bears. But then in 2003, like, his 14th year living there, one of them just fucking ate him, right? As you would probably expect.
How did he initiate the bear living situation? Did the bears just welcome him?
I think, like, he thought, like, he had worked his way into, like, their social society. Like, they thought he was just, like, a human bear. But then... You know, one of the bears just, like, ate him.
Then
what's great is that the documentary is so good. It was on TV last night, like, uncut. And I had seen it before, but I was like, I'm going to watch this again because this is awesome. And to be fair, that's true. It was a bear from somewhere else. And everyone was like, this is a mean old bear. Like, this bear was just a son of a bitch. You know,
there were two golden keys drop in the same room. I don't think I've ever had that happen before.
That is certainly a rarity.
Yeah.
But the great thing about the documentary is that Werner Herzog approaches the subject with such, like, sensitivity and respect. And he's like, you know, I understand that he's like this great German accent. So he's like, well, I understand that Timothy did not fit in with the world of the humans.
That's kind of Dutch.
Well, okay, I'm doing my best here, alright?
That's alright.
Cal Sands, thank you as well. There's a moment that's so good. It's like after he gets killed... Werner Herzog just unleashes, like, the most erudite savage burn you could possibly do. And he's like, well, I feel sympathy for Timothy Treadwell. When I look at the cold, unfeeling eyes of the bear, I see no sensitivity, no friendship, just an empty stare that indicates a hunger for food. And then I'm like, damn, dude, you just spent like 2 hours treating this dude's story with like all this, you know, respect and reverence and understanding. And then you're like, all right. In keeping with all that, though, I mean, this thing just wants to eat your ass. Not eat your ass. You get the idea, though.
Yeah, like, I get the idea.
You can look. I tweeted it, but you can also find the quote on IMDb for Grizzly Man. It's like the most well-researched, savage, unnecessary burn of a man who is already dead. It's like the ultimate I told you so, but in such devastating, like, Neil deGrasse Tyson fashion that it's almost hilarious.
If the very idea of an I told you so to a dead person is just kind of amazing by itself.
Exactly. But I would really recommend
the
movie is not a comedy. Like, it's actually you're if I tell you the story, you go, "Oh, that dude's an idiot for living with the bears." And he is, and I think that's almost like indisputable. But you come to understand him a little bit by the end of the documentary. You're like, he's had some problems in his life, and he thought that this was like, you know, a way for him to escape them and also do something good for them. Like, he had noble intentions, despite
being misguided. I'm making it sound even weirder than I actually think it is. People do weird stuff all the time, and, you know, not everybody fits into a box.
That's fine. And it, like, the fact that he lived there for like 14 years is incredible.
Yeah, that's why I said it's sad that the bear ate him, because like, that seemed to apparently bring him a lot of happiness.
It's really like biting the hand that feeds, too. Yeah. Because he was like the greatest bear ally. But like, half the people they interview are like, because they interview people like from Alaska, you know, people who have like encountered bears. And half the people are like, you know, he's very sensitive, you know, he just wanted to help the bears. Half the people are like, this guy is a fucking moron. Like, this guy like set back bear ecology like 30 years with his ignorance, but it's so good. I would really recommend it.
Yeah, I get both his perspectives.
So all you guys need to do is subscribe to Knowledge British Columbia and then go back in time and watch it 24 hours ago.
Makes sense. It was contract below, by the way. That's why I got the two keys. I just forgot I had it.
Okay. Apparently I also got that and just didn't even notice. Chat was like, what are you doing? I can't believe this has only been a half hour. This run is like so good.
Yeah, it's doing very well. Capricorn, I got the Mind, I've got Death's Touch, Synth Oil, Cat of Nine Tails. I'll stop now.
Oh, I get you. I mean, I see them there.
In a lot of times when I say all the names, it's just like, yeah, do I still remember all the names of these? Yep. All right, cool.
In your tweet, you say that Grizzly Man hits the PFT note. What is the PFT note? That's noted comedian and improviser Paul F. Tompkins does a Werner Herzog impression, and the broad note of it is that everything comes back to nature will eventually destroy us, and that's on display in that
I
thought
movie. It was like the prostate fluorolactate.
Well, that's actually
valve or something.
What, like, he was
it
named
helps
after.
The bear milk itself or something like
it
that.
It helps the bear milk itself. It actually is.
I thought that's how he made the bears like him, was he gave them all bear orgasms.
Right, yeah, no. They show a lot of that. It's very vulgar.
Well, it's, you know, it's just nature.
I mean, it is PG-13, so, you know, the Motion Picture Association of America lets you have at least one bear orgasm in the movie. As long as his dick isn't above 45 degrees. Relative to his
pubis.
Yeah,
that's the weirdest part of that job, working for the MPAA, is measuring the bear dicks.
Yeah, it's like, you gotta get your protractor out and be like, sorry, this bear dick is at 60 degrees. That indicates, you know, sexual arousal that's offensive. If it was 54 degrees, it wouldn't be a problem.
I'm just thinking about the trainer that's gotta hold the bear in the position so he doesn't jerk wrong and then the measurement's off.
I think about that all the time. It's like really a dream job.
I don't know, it's a dream job for some, but it's a very niche job.
Oh, man.
You know, there's somebody for everybody out there. Same with jobs. If that's your calling, measuring bear dicks.
People sometimes talk about, like, how weird it is to be, like, someone who gets semen from animals. You know, the dude who has to, like, hold the... Yeah, he, like, holds the horse's dick while it fucks this, like, fake horse vagina, right? How weird would it be to be the dude making the fake horse vagina? And you gotta be like, oh, this is gonna make this horse cum buckets, right? Like, that's so much weirder to me than being like, all right, I'm gonna guide your dick in. Instead, you gotta, like, you're architecting something that's gonna make another animal cum. Your brain Your brain has to be, like, on a different level that I cannot even fathom, I think.
If you're just designing, like, a silicone, like, rubber horse vagina or something, it's like, you know, you never see the horse dick unless you built one.
But, like, how do you know? How do you know what works and what doesn't, man?
You take a model from a dead horse's vagina and you just...
That's so much... That's, like, some awful Tim Burton-esque shit right there, like, that I could not handle. This
but
dude's...
Nature designed it already. They don't have to do anything.
This dude's 3D modeling like a dead horse vagina. He goes in at work at 9 in the morning and does that. That scares the shit out of me.
There's scientists that do all kinds of shit. I mean, I don't know if this counts as a science, but it's like kind of in that realm.
But you know there's got to be like one dude who's like, I get it. We've been making... First off, there's, you know, horse semen tech. They've been making, you know, the number one horse vagina on the market for like 20 years. But you know what? We put a new twist on ours. It's got a little like 90 degree twist just before the cervix.
Like, yeah.
These horse, like he's talking to like
the
farmers.
For horses,
I guess. He's like, your horses aren't gonna come harder than they've ever come before with this horse vagina.
All right, when you put it like that, that's kind of a different realm. I looked at it very like, clinically, like it's just like you gotta do this job and you make the thing for it. But you're looking at it like you're getting into how to make this horse come as hard as
possible. Well, I'm thinking about it like there's a whole process here, right? Like there's one dude who's making it and he's like he's got a passion for it because it's just building, it's engineering, right? But then somebody has to work on the sales and marketing team for like the company that makes horses come buckets. And he's gotta go and like put on a suit and a nice cologne and go to these farmers and be like, let me tell you, your horses have never come like they're gonna come with our fake horse vagina. And then the farmer,
what's amazing too is it's like a funeral. It's not for the person, it's for the person who's still there. Right, so it's for the horse vagina is for the farmer more than it is for the horse, because the horse doesn't care. Horse is going to come buckets no matter what it has.
That's probably true.
So but it's like, really to appeal to the farmer.
But, like, maybe you get, like, you know, extra breeding efficiency or something if that happens. I don't know. This
I've
is one right.
Max horse breeding, personally.
I'd really like to hear what Malph would say on the subject. I feel like
he'd know everything about this.
His unique brand of insight would prove very useful here, so we'll maybe keep that topic on the forefront for when he comes back.
Are there any horse farmers in chat that know more about this stuff?
I mean, wait, now that I think about it, well, no, that's, you do take, like, semen from horses, right? You don't just bring the horse to the other place. You probably, like, there's a market, and you're like, I don't want a local horse. I want the horse, and it's in Montana, and I'm in Iowa. And actually, those are pretty geographically close together, but ignoring that.
They'll breed them, if they're on the same ranch together, they'll breed them in the same place. But if they need to do something like that, yeah, they can do the insemination separately.
Animals, fucking weird, dude.
Fuck her right in the horse pussy.
Oh,
oh no.
It is.
Do you have a subject? Wow. Do you have a thought on this subject, Malph?
Oh, he probably danned us.
He totally danned us. Yeah, that's fine.
I didn't want him to dan us this time.
I was really interested to see what he had to say.
I want to hear about his danimals.
He told us to fuck her right in the horse pussy.
Yeah.
It's a sentence I don't even like saying. Just kidding.
There can only be one Dan to Dan people.
Oh my god.
I love this. Whatever this meta is, I love it.
We're just gonna get Dan on a regular basis. You know what's gonna be the worst? Is when somebody shows up and we actually don't know who it is. That's gonna be terrifying.
My single most important job is seeing to that never ever happening.
That's a good point, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna try my best. And if I do fail you, then I apologize in advance.
It's okay, you know, it happens.
I don't want that to happen.
There can be only one Dan to Dan people.
Not
wrong. I think about it that way, he's got a good point. Yo, I started an Azazel run. This is like the greatest run I've ever seen in my life. Floor 2, Magic Mush, Tammy's Head, Brimstone, Maw of the Void, and my trinket is a tapeworm that just makes your range not be totally shitty.
So you're like one step away from becoming some sort of like curling pretzel of blood lasers.
I would actually say I'm one step ahead of that.
Oh, you're ahead of that.
Because like when the rubber cement Azazel shots hit the wall, they become infinite range.
Beautiful.
So it's creating a nice little array here. This is a really good discussion for conversation early in the show today.
Yeah, I'm really not sure how we got there, but you know, whatever.
I have another thing to talk about now that, and it's another thing that Malph is probably going to be quite eager to discuss. This is Red Wars. Thank you for the subscription. And that's, I think we've really gone too far with hamburgers, Nick. I think
what
we
makes
might
you say that.
I think we might just be done with burgers. I was thinking about it today, and I'm like, man, if I go to like a diner or something, I would rather order anything but a hamburger. And you know why that's the case?
No, why?
I've been burned on too many tall burgers. The tallness of the American hamburger is getting out of control.
They just got to put a toothpick in it.
It doesn't help that much. In my opinion, it doesn't help that much. You go and you're like, hey, can I order a meal that will dislocate my entire jaw, please? Oh yeah, here we go.
Out of it.
We got a house smoked Alberta beef Angus burger that has another house smoked Alberta beef Angus burger on top of it. You got to eat it. Here's the chainsaw to carve it.
Look, I'm not going to disagree that the burger race is a race to the bottom. However, I do think there's plenty of happy mediums that exist in the world of burger influence.
If you can't take a bite that encapsulates all of the ingredients, it's a waste of a burger as far as I'm concerned.
So don't eat that one. Get a different one.
Yeah, but then they're like, well, we've got A1 peppercorn burger. It's 18 inches tall. And you're like, well, do you have anything smaller than that? You're like, yeah. The cheeseburger.
You can get some mushrooms and Swiss on it. It'll be just fine.
Now, that one, I'll give you that one. I just don't like mushrooms on a burger. That's my own personal thing.
Sure, but lots of people do, though. I do.
I recognize that I'm in the minority maybe on that one. I'm just sick of the ones, like, for me, an ideal burger is, like, a really nice beef cooked properly, slice of cheese, you know, maybe a few red onions, a pickle, lettuce leaf, you're good to go. I hate
the
ones...
America, we don't do red onions here.
You don't do red onions in America?
They're communist.
Oh, I see what you're saying, okay. You do red onions, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. I was like, that's crazy, man. But
I
now it's...
that better.
Now it's like... You know, here's your burger. It comes with 4 onion rings on top of it, and then, you know, a deep-fried calzone. And then on top of that, we drizzled maple syrup, and then, like, here's 6 chestnuts roasted over an open fire. And then the garnish is like a slider. So you got, like, a little burger on top of your burger. And then you take one bite, and the whole thing just fucking collapses. It's like the Vasa.
If you bite it and the burger shoots out of the back, like, that's probably not ideal.
And the more toppings you have that are not actually connected, the more the plate tectonics becomes a factor, I think, you know?
Don't use my term.
Lettuce are the key.
Yo, I'm... Malph.
What?
What is your thought on this subject of big burgers?
And horse breeding.
First of all, I'd like people to know I coined the term plate tectonics of
sandwiches.
That's
correct, yes.
That's okay. I agree with Ryan. I think it's like poutine. You should try and keep it simple.
I agree with you on that.
I mean, okay, any burger, I feel like, I don't know what your feeling is on sauces, but some burgers they get going with too many sauces. Yeah, like 2 pretty much would be my max. And even then that's sometimes too much depending on what the sauce is. Cuz they're all just going to kind of blend together and become like a blob of sauce.
Confirmed, yeah.
To me, you know, I'm not a huge fan of tomatoes in general, but like, you gotta be careful with your tomato game. I see some pretty thick tomato slices out there, and I don't think they contribute anything to the overall flavor profile. The general texture is
What if you get a tomato that's like been in the wrong part of the fridge, and then when it comes out, it's like almost ice? You bite into it, and like it just completely compromises the warmth of the burger.
I gotta disagree on the flavor problem. Like, that really does add something to me. I can taste the tomato through it, and it actually adds a bunch.
I mean, I can taste the tomato, but it's just like it's not a very
good vegetable.
It's yeah, it's just like, I don't know, I feel like the taste and the flavor isn't really contributing to the overall awesomeness of it.
On
I'd
a
rather
general
have...
sandwich, tomato is the make or break sometimes for me.
Whoa.
What? Tomato's a big deal, man.
If you ask me, like, if there was like a dystopian future where I constructed the death row inmates' last meals, like they had personally wronged me and I got to construct their last meals, I would make them like a white bread sandwich with tomato. And then that would be it. And then the bread would get all weird and pink. And then, you know, it'd be like one slice of Oscar Mayer bologna on it. And that's it.
I read that last meals are sort of a myth. Like, they don't really get to choose whatever they want on death row. It's just, like, whatever they had in the cafeteria that day.
That'd be, like, fucked up, though, right? Because what if they were like, you know, I want innocence. You'd be like, oh, shit, you got us. Let him go, boys. I want a retrial.
It would be a monkey paw situation. Somehow it would turn out worse.
Yeah, it's like wishing for more wishes, man.
Don't do it. Don't try that.
When I worked at the general store, the main guy used to eat tomato sandwiches.
Like just tomato.
He'd get a big slice of tomato or two, you know, overlap them, salt and pepper, and then white bread. And he usually wouldn't even toast it. And then I was pretty resistant to it. But he's like, no, it's really good. And it's like, I don't even really like tomatoes, but like, fuck it, I'll try it. And it was actually like, yeah, that's what you use to torture people with.
I thought you were going to say that I actually liked it.
No.
You just doubled down in the other direction.
That's so good.
No.
It was you just really like, caught me off guard with that.
It was just like funky tasting like water, like with a slight bite to it. I don't know.
Water with a bite.
It's like, you ever know somebody that's like, you know, I eat raw potatoes. Like, just a salt and pepper, I'll have like a raw potato, just bite into it. You're like, are you? And like, this happened in college. Somebody told me, like, yeah, you just get a little salt and pepper. You just put that on a raw potato, take a bite. It's like a potato chip. I tried it once. The person's out of their fucking mind. It was horrible. It tasted like eating a shirt.
This reminds me of the scene in Napoleon Dynamite when the farmer's like stirring up the egg yolks.
Oh.
He's like, we got some egg salad. And then they all walk up and there's like flies buzzing on it. And
yeah.
Like, I don't want that. And then one guy tries one.
When you think about it, how many, like, there's a lot of vegetables that are pretty much like A-OK, either cooked in various ways or raw. You know, broccoli, I'll do some good broccoli raw.
Absolutely.
You get some cabbage and carrot and all that stuff and make a nice coleslaw. You don't need to cook that shit. But potatoes are one of the few. They're amazing, but only when they're like cooked in any variety of way.
Correct. I agree with that assessment strongly. Vehemently, actually.
It's good. It's good.
But what about the subject of artificial horse pussies?
You really want to know?
I don't know. Do you really want to tell me?
They're for the farmer, not for the horse, right?
I feel like, you know, okay, what's your opinion on people who do, like, autopsies and, like, build anatomical
can't stand them.
Models of animals in general? Would you be like, that's a gross, weird job?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
You know, but it's sort of necessary for society.
More so
regardless.
Than, like, doing it for a human?
There's something, like, weirder about the horse vagina, though, because you're doing it for the pleasure of a different species, which is strange to me, like on a sexual level.
They don't take pleasure in it the same way we do. Only dolphins do.
I think they probably do, though.
It's different. Man, no, some guy's not good. Any dude who's making a model for a horse, like I'm making a model of a horse pussy for a horse cock, isn't
going
to be
say
doing it.
Please don't say that.
What?
Horse pussy. I really don't
you
like
just
the
said it.
I can say it. When I say it, it doesn't sound as weird as when you say it.
What if we're all offended by you saying it?
Are you? Nobody's
I like it when he says it.
Nobody's
it rocks my jollies and my jellies.
It does something a little weird.
No, but like the guy, I mean, it's a job. Like the one dude spent an afternoon making a model. They send it to a factory and then they just start injecting rubber into it. And that's it.
A lot of injecting going on. Yeah.
You're telling me.
I don't like he's not going to be like, oh, man. Yeah, this horse is going to love this. He's just going to be like,
I think he'd be like that.
If he's any good at his job,
yeah,
I don't
you gotta head like love what you do. You never work a day in your life.
About horse pussy.
Horses don't care. It's not like it's you're trying to find new and interesting ways to get a horse off. It's not like they jerk off every day and it's like their dick loses sensitivity.
That's like, what Ryan was saying. They're putting a twist in it now.
Well, I'm just saying you'd still want to have the twist either way, right?
You could think they are ready to go, no matter what you give them.
No, you could put. Just like hang a yogurt cup off of a door, a horse's dick, and you'd come.
You don't think a yogurt, they wouldn't fit.
It'd fill it up.
Cup.
It'd fill it up again.
I see.
Hang it on the tip. Okay, I gotcha.
Yeah, like just the slightest breeze probably gets a horse going.
That's probably true. It's like I never want to like go to a farm again in my life. I feel
you're
like
you have to do all of this if you do.
When you're like a kid and you go to a farm, you're like. Wow, all these animals are so big and majestic. And then when you're an adult, you're like, these things like are just desperate for a fuck. And then like, if you died right next to them, they would eat your corpse. If you broke your leg next to them, like at night, they would just eat you by morning. You'd have no chance to get away. Animal kingdoms.
I think they're generally gentler than that, aren't they?
As fucked up as humans are, I'm so glad that we're like the height of evolution right now because like, it would be so much worse if like fucking. You know, bats
be in that farm.
What if like bats ruled the world, dude? That'd be fucked up.
That'd be fine. They only live in caves, so like most of the world would be left untarnished.
Not at night, though, right? Like at night,
they pull us into the caves. No, they
each bat eats up to 3,000 bugs a night, man. If anything, they should be the leaders.
Fuck, you're selling me pretty hard right now.
All
right, I chose the wrong animal.
Bats 2016.
Yeah.
Okay, what's your top, like, because we're shitting on animals, what's your top, like, three, like, I hope this animal never goes extinct,
yeah.
And we can't say bees, because we all know we're
right.
fucked
That's,
if bees
yeah,
are gone.
I understand. Okay, I mean, I'm a big cat fan, you know, domesticated cats, I feel like if I died in my apartment, Ruka and Toma would wait, like, as long as they could before eating me. So, I take that as a sign of loyalty.
I don't think they would.
Nah,
I don't think they would starve to death.
Personal,
I don't think they would starve to death, but I think they would wait. Like a dog, I could see starving to death. For Ruka and Tomo, I think they'd probably wait like a you know until.
I think they'd give it like a
wait a weekend,
a couple hours. That is ridiculous.
I think Tomo would give it longer, and Ruka would like dive in.
Well, you know, honestly, that's what I respect about Ruka is that he'll do anything
to
survive.
He knows what he wants.
He'll do anything to survive. If I was in a survival situation and they died, I would make a logical decision about eating them. I wouldn't feel good about it. I'd be in extreme distress, but I'd still, like, I'd do it.
I really don't think I could bring myself to eat a pet no matter what happens.
What if they had died first, though?
I still don't think I could do it.
You're kind of, like, honoring them by eating them, right? That at least that's what I've been telling myself in RimWorld while I let all of the animals slow down the raiders while I get ready for the assault.
That's first why thing, I can't watch that anymore. It's too sad.
First thing you do when you get a cat as your starting pet in RimWorld is you slaughter it and...
No!
You have to! They're so useless. The
I
bear
hate this
will...
conversation now.
No, bears will kill them right away. If anything, you're doing them a favor. So you just sneak up on them and do it when they're not ready.
I wish you could program your turrets in RimWorld to just shoot animals on sight. Like, not the ones that are part of your colony, but I don't want, like, a grizzly bear.
All animals.
I don't want a grizzly bear walking into my colony and then just, like, eating my corn, right? Like, the turrets should just shoot it immediately. Yeah.
They always go mad anyway.
Yeah, it's just a matter of time until they... Like, the bear doesn't know that he's trespassing. He's just like, whoa, this forest looks weird. There's a geothermal power plant right here. Whoa, strange.
I haven't looked for that specifically, but I'm almost positive there's going to be a mod for it already because I feel very much the same way. And then, like, I've had some, like, Arctic wolves come in. They hang out for a bit. I'm like, all right, that's cool. Like, just do your thing. I'm not going to worry about it. And then they start killing my boars and stuff, and I'm like, alright, well, I guess I'm gonna have to just, like, put a bullet in your head.
You gotta kill him!
Yeah, you gotta do it.
It's pretty weird that isn't built into the game, honestly, because they have every freaking control for everything.
Wow. Tynan really? Has...
Only said. Some animals can go in this door sometimes during the day.
Nah. He's working on Alpha 16, and one of the things he tweeted a week or two back was like, alright, guys, how do we make animals not useless during fights? Which is... You know,
it's
I almost think if you don't care about the animals in your colony, they're overpowered. Like, I had a huge raid come by, and I was just like, all right, you guys stall them. And I'm just going to, like, send Nick in, who's incapable of violence, to kite them into my kill box. And then, you know, I lost a few dromedaries in the process, but it's not like they were doing anything else except for eating my fucking crops anyway.
Dromedary alert. Yeah, I can't haul, nor can I commit violence.
I'm not saying that horse vaginas are, like, fake horse vaginas are made of dead horses. I'm just, what Nick has suggested, and I think it makes sense, is that they probably used a dead horse at some point to build the model, you know?
To model them.
Yeah.
Oh, no, no, you know what they do, like, in the science museums, they take a corpse of anything, and then they freeze it.
Oh.
And then they get the deli meat slicer, and they slice it in very thin layers and scan each section. So I know they've done that with horses before. So that's probably how they made the 3D model. And, you know, no rubber necessary to, like, make a mold.
Yeah, that's, no rubber necessary if you're a horse.
That's like the bodies exhibit. And then you're like, whoa, that exhibit was really cool to see, like, what's inside of a human being. Where'd you get these bodies from, like, organ donors or something? And they're like, hey, by the way, make sure to go hit up the gift shop before you leave. It'll answer any questions you might have over there after you make a transaction.
Earth is pretty wild. It's cool, you know.
I'm super ready for robots, dude. Animals are fucked up. It just, like, it would, like, robots, what are they driven by? Whatever you program them to be driven by, right? Robots, you can make a robot that's like, your goal is to make, like, this fucking subway tunnel. And then it drills until it fucking dies, you repair it, and it goes back
until
to drilling.
It becomes self-aware and kills all the humans.
No, but
that's what
even
happen.
Then, like, a robot, it, you know, it can't necessarily go against this programming. Whereas a human being is like, oh, what do you value in life? Oh, justice and equality overall. But if you literally deprive me of food and water for like 2 days, I would murder my best friend to eat a single meal. Like, we all have that weakness within us.
There's, with the programming and stuff, though, I watched this, there's this YouTube channel, whatever. It's some weird name. It's like, Curiosagot or
Yeah.
Curiosagot.
No, that he makes like the cool science videos with real slick editing.
Yeah, they're really cool. So they did one within the past few months, and they're just talking about different ways in which humans will, like, AI would cause us to, like, commit genocide or something. And one was like even just a really weird scenario where you could program a robot to, like, make ice cream, do it forever, right? And you think that's innocent enough, but then eventually the robot is gonna run out of ingredients to make the ice cream, but it's like it's programmed to just, like, keep making it.
Yeah,
so it's
especially if it's
finding...
in my colony.
Saying it's gonna make people ice cream?
Yeah, it's gonna start finding different ways to make ice cream, and eventually it's just gonna start, like, slaughtering humans and turning us to a pulp and then freezing us. It would be like Froyo. But
that seems reasonable, actually.
I feel like, though, you really only have to write, like, one conditional statement for that. You'd be like, you know, is your closest ingredient a human being? And if that's the case, then don't make ice cream out of them.
No, but I commented that line out.
Oh, you what? Yeah, that's, gotcha. You don't want to put, you know, your debug statements in a production code. Whoops, accidentally destroyed the human race. Got them all turned into ice cream. We should have never given the...
Like a thing that'll happen.
We should have never given the ice cream robot a, you know, artillery shell.
I'm still amazed by what the human body can turn into over time. I saw the Boggs exhibit, and that was just wild. These people were beef jerky men.
Yeah.
Like, the way Dark Souls is, but, like, worse. And it was real. Like, yeah, you could see the outline of his features on his face, because it was amazingly well-preserved, and you could see his red chin hair still coming out of his chin.
Well, you know,
his whole body was flattened like a piece
like,
of paper.
That's actually, like, one of my overarching fears in life, is that I will become one of those exhibits. Because, you know, there's that famous, you know, proto-human that was found, Lucy, the Australopithecus afarensis, right?
Oh, yeah.
And
it's a hot one.
It's, like, it's an extremely important discovery when it comes to anthropology and, you know, even history to some extent. And you know how she died? She fucking fell out of a tree and landed in a bog and then was preserved forever. So everybody that ever learns about her, you got to be like, well, this fucking moron fell out of a tree and got trapped in a bog and preserved.
Look at my Isaac character. It's Ryan. I don't think I've ever run into an Isaac character that looks so much like you.
What do you mean? Just default Isaac with double
shot? I'm Azazel with 2020, and for some reason, it really looks like Ryan.
You know Azazel's... He's black.
I'm talking about his facial features.
Just... I mean, I guess. I can understand that.
I watched a documentary last night. Well, actually, I watched a couple, but one was called... It's on Netflix, too. I recommend it for people. It's called Into the Furno.
Into the Furno.
Into the Furno.
Sorry, into Inferno or in the Inferno.
I have to say that.
What is a Furno?
Into the Furno is the worst name for a media property I've ever heard.
The name of my death metal band. Come on.
Into the Furno.
Sorry, I've been mixing up my words a lot lately. I think maybe my brain is turning to mush.
You know what? I'm glad you said that because I'm doing that a lot as well. So.
It's like really weird to the point where I'm starting to think like my brain is actually turning to mush because I'll say like I'll switch like the first letter of like the first word and put it on the second word and then the first letter of the second word and put it. It's just like I'll say stuff like bass backwards or but I'll do it with a.
Well, I mean, if it makes you feel better, a little earlier today, I suggested that you got esophageal cancer from eating Catherine Zeta-Jones' vagina.
Oh, no, I heard about it. Don't worry about it.
Word travels fast.
Yeah. But anyways, in the movie, they were talking about this one super volcano. I think it was, like, in Ethiopia or somewhere around there. And they don't have super strong evidence, but they think at the time that it erupted, it dwindled the human population down to approximately 600 people.
That's messed up.
And that they, you know, they were the reason why we exist today because however they survived, they like, you know, because of the volcanic winters and shit, right? Like a lot of vegetation dies and that means a lot of animals die and so on and so forth. So,
and thus the Lannisters were born.
Yeah, man. It's wild. And then they went to North Korea and, you know, there's like this big volcano in North Korea that's like hugely important to their culture.
Yeah, that was funny for some reason. I don't know why.
Well, it was a weird transition in the they started like looking at videos and stuff of flowing volcanoes and all these scientists and then they go to South Korea or North Korea for the second half and it's just like
what is this movie called?
Why are you guys talking about Korean
Into
volcanoes?
The Inferno.
in the Inferno or something along. It's a Netflix original that's like a new release.
Into the Inferno. It's a Werner Herzog movie, man.
We were just talking about him earlier.
We were just talking about Werner Herzog. He makes documentaries about how nature is going to kill us all despite its beauty.
No, it will. Guaranteed.
Yeah, it's definitely going to kill us all eventually, yes.
Unless we reach class 2 civilization, in which case we'll be able to harness the energy of volcanoes.
We're on civilization 6, so we're already almost there. All we need is to go negative 4 civilizations, and then we, you know, just get rid of our Dyson spheres. For now, I'm done my... Isaac run. So I'm going to issue a siren klaxon that we're about to begin speedrunners in 3 minutes. See you soon.
Oh, thank you.
I apologize. I thought you guys were...
Oh, you don't need to apologize, Rob. We were talking about Werner Herzog.
I heard that, yeah. I mean, he's pretty cool.
Have you seen Grizzly Man?
I've seen bits and pieces, but I haven't.
Oh, that's not that's in poor taste, Rob.
probably the bad words to use there. Yeah. what? How the? Okay, Speedrunners is confusing to me now. Okay, never mind. We're good.
Ish.
But yeah, no, I saw a little bit of it. There's that's pretty cool.
It's I would describe it as a seminal documentary.
Like, it's very much like semen.
Well, if you want to, you know, be Latin, I guess.
Take it to the root word, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. you know, I'm weird in that, like,
No kidding.
Yeah, well, I don't really like documentaries unless, and this is a really weird unless. unless they're like really dry, boring documentaries.
Yeah. I can understand that.
I love those. Like, I could watch that shit for like 20 hours a day, but like an actual good documentary that's constructed and made by a documentarian is, it's just like, eh.
Take it or leave it.
Waste of time.
Yeah, I don't really care.
Can you guys join on me?
I will attempt to do so.
Difficult question to answer, but I'll give it a shot.
Oh wait, no, I can invite friends with a controller, actually.
I joined on you, though.
I am a friend with a controller.
This is a new era. I accidentally invited Pyrian Flax. I'm sorry.
Don't count your chickens.
I got Pyrian on here.
We were gonna at one point, I remember.
Mm-hmm. I played Blood Bowl with that guy.
I think we were DMing one time. I was like, you should be on the show. And he's like, yeah, I'll be on the show.
And fucking roasted my ass and didn't even question it.
Scream Runners were playing.
Did you slide into the DMs?
Yeah, dude.
What'd you do in there?
Slide around, slip and slide, do the crocodile run.
You did a slip and slide with P-Flax?
Yeah.
Pretty sweet.
It was easy.
I was gonna say dope. After I started saying sweet. Yeah, so I didn't want to say swope. Like,
yeah.
I don't like swope.
I don't know, it's a little bit of a dangerous...
Is
you
it?
You watch any Louis Theroux documentaries?
Theroux?
Is Theroux, Louis Theroux?
No, it's Theroux, isn't it?
No, it's Henry David Thoreau. This is Louis Theroux.
Oh.
It's Theroux.
Anyone else see that Michael A.L. Fox's name actually just
Lion
says...
Theroux.
Mike A.L. Alpha?
What?
Your name A.L. for Alpha. Me just says Mick A.L. Alpha.
I don't know.
No, it's normal like, on mine.
For me, what? It says Mick A.L. Alpha.
I mean, Twilight. It sounds exquisite. Wait, why does Ryan's shark look like Ryan?
What are you talking about?
Shark?
He's been this guy for ages.
Yeah.
Yeah, but his head is in the shark.
Yeah. It's life.
That's not me. That's Gil. It's completely different.
Thank you, Shaw Bob, and Meat6696 for your subscriptions, by the way. I got two different PobChacks. So I'm happy to see those. PobChacks are my favorite chacks.
How do you play this game?
Baby PobChack.
Oh, you know, God, it's so bright!
Since this is a returning I guess now all the levels have Halloween things. I was gonna say, like, why don't we do the whatchamacallit? Some of the custom levels.
We tried that once. I think it was a problem for some reason.
We've already spent so much time learning these ones.
That's true. Which is why I'm gonna
framey as shit though.
Yeah.
It's framey?
Yeah, it's always been framey. Well, I thought it would be better by now.
For me it looks nice.
No, wait, hold up, guys. I'm just getting used to it now.
I am going to die!
Oh,
I am alive!
Power.
Is there?
Yeah, I just had a skull I shot into the ceiling.
I think that's just like a...
Oh, was that the missile, maybe?
Yeah, probably.
Oh, dude, I still got it.
I don't.
Those.
I've never had it.
Blocks, they're so spooky!
I'm the less of the had it.
The muscle memory is so real!
Ah!
You're less of the has it.
I am the less of the has it! That sounds like something out of Dune.
The muscle memory is so real!
Ah!
Hey now.
What's You're that, awesome. What's the Cuisinart thing that they do in Dune?
No, we Cuisin in Chicken Horse.
Yeah, we Cuisin in Ultimate Chicken Horse on occasion. On a Cuisin.
But what do they call him? He's like the Cuisart Paramount or something?
Nope.
I actually have, I've never seen Dune.
Really?
Yeah.
What?
It's not that good, honestly, but...
I've seen Doom with Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
And Carl Urban.
And Keith Urban.
And Keith Urban. And Jody Messina.
Oh, the Cuisinart? That.
Mouth,
making
how much,
up words, Rob.
How much speedrunners have you played? Because if you haven't played a lot, you're in for a bad time, buddy.
Who are you talking to me?
I'm talking to you.
Oh, no, I mean, you know, I've won the grand championship.
Oh, really? I didn't know.
Nah, I'm not very good at it.
You're supposed to read Dune, not watch it? Okay.
Yeah, people saying not that good, but yeah, no, apparently, like, I think that's, like, largely the consensus, is that the movie's not that great, but the book is, like, really good.
I've decided to exclusively watch like Werner Herzog movies.
Have you? You gonna have the one about like gorillas fucking a man or something?
What?
I don't know, I'd watch it.
That's Uwe Boll. What? You're right, there is a skull! There's like you throw like an alien skull!
It's Halloween! Ow.
Oh.
The crystal skull.
Yeah, this is the kingdom of the crystal skull.
One of the best Indiana Jones movies.
I think it's one of the three best, if I'm being honest.
Suck it, dick fuck! Wait, how many were there in total?
There's four Indiana Jones movies.
No, there's three. Don't worry about it.
I'd say it's the fifth best one.
That's ridiculous.
I would actually rather watch Young Indiana Jones than watch Kingdom of the Crystal Skull.
Crystal Skull's better than Temple of Doom, you fuckers.
No.
I highly
Doom is probably the best one.
Points! No.
You're just shitting the bed here.
No, I'm just being honest.
Incorrect is what you're doing.
That's the one with the little kid, right?
Yeah, if,
yeah, from Goonies.
Pull out people's
hearts.
That's
what I did. Booty trap.
Short
please.
I really like that one, actually.
I would really like you to not do that impression ever again.
Oh, wait. Are you saying you like Temple of Doom best?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, okay. I thought you were saying you like Crystal Skull.
No, I was playing with that one.
The best is ridiculous.
Yeah.
I was playing with that. The other one, though, was...
There are people who are wrong who think Temple of Doom is the best, but, you know, that's fine. That's fine. As long as you're not saying Crystal Skull's the best, you know.
Part of growing up and being an adult is being wrong a lot.
Yeah.
So, like, I'm fine with being wrong about this. It's really a very minor problem.
You mean they're making a new one?
Excuse me?
Yeah.
They're always making a new everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do make a lot of new things.
It's gonna be fucking Harrison Ford in a walker beating up Nazis.
Harrison Ford's already so rich, though, like... Damn.
Where's my family? See that video?
No, I did not see that video. What is that video?
All right, well,
where's his family?
It's literally a compilation of Harrison Ford saying, like, where's my family in various
other
movies.
Related things?
Oh!
Yeah, because he
delightful. He
often plays in movies. Yeah, like in like all of his movies. He's always losing his family.
Yeah.
He's a really bad dad, apparently.
He plays
bad. You don't have
dad.
To be a bad dad to lose your family. Sometimes shit happens. Look at Liam Neeson.
Look at Home Alone.
No,
yeah,
I am Wrath. So good.
I mean, there is that common joke about Taken where it's just like, you know, by the third time, you got to start considering, like,
right.
You're just bad at this.
Like, how many times can you lose your family? Wait, isn't the third one he's taken, though?
No, and the third one his wife gets taken.
Yeah.
But he shot his wife.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he shot the French guy's wife, not his wife.
She was very taken with him.
Spoilers.
I mean, it didn't change much about the movie. Wait. He just shoots wives.
Wasn't Taken 2 the same as John Wick 1?
Yeah, Taken 2 came out before John Wick 1.
I know,
but
isn't there one where they take Taken Boy's dog?
I haven't seen John Wick, spoilers.
Boy?
I was gonna say, are you guys super into John Wick? Because I didn't think it was that great.
I didn't mind. I mean, okay, it's not the most realistic thing, obviously, but I thought the action sequences were pretty fun.
Yeah, they're cool. I mean, like, it's just like when people saw John Wick, there's like the second coming of Christ, and I was
it was actually the second coming of Dread.
I'd like to see another one of those. They should bring that back. Carl Urban.
He's also in, what was I going to say?
No,
that
dead.
Movie that we were talking about earlier, Carl Urban is in it, and
Star
you said
Trek.
Keith Inferno? Urban.
Star Trek.
You said it was Keith Urban.
Yeah, I remember saying that. I don't remember what movie it was.
Doom!
Mentioned a lot of movies. Dune?
You mean he's in Dune?
He was in Doom!
Ridiculous?
He's in Doom!
He was Colonel Sanders.
Chronicles of Riddick.
He is in Chronicles of Riddick as well.
No, the other one.
No, he's in Chronicles of Riddick, though.
No, the other one.
Did you guys see the new
Chronicles of Riddick movies?
The other one?
I saw them both.
No, did you? There was a third one.
Oh, there was a third one!
Yeah. Did you guys see it?
No.
It was pretty good!
I thought I had like a 4 on Rotten Tomatoes.
I mean, I liked it. I thought it was a lot more pitch blacky, which was kind of cool.
When did it come out?
Like a year or two ago, something like
I
that.
I think it was like 2013.
No.
No, I don't think I heard of it at all.
Yeah. It's one of those
straight
things.
Straight to VHS.
Yeah. You guys play Butcher Bay? I heard it was real good.
I heard that game was awesome.
Yeah, never played it.
Rob, you gotta stop Nick from winning, please.
That's not gonna happen, to be totally honest with you.
Just don't get hit by this. Alright, mission accomplished.
He couldn't have avoided it under any circumstance.
Oh my god.
Yeah. 15-year-olds. Pitch Black is cool.
I like
Pitch Black is for 13-year-olds. It's pretty dark.
It's for like 15-year-olds. I don't know if it's for 13-year-olds.
Yeah.
Thank you, Alex Timo, and the Real Foster Forest for your 26 months in a row subscriptions.
My bad.
It's cool. I'll just ready up again.
I'm pretty pissed off at you, honestly.
Is this I hit B one too many times?
Problem.
Good, you got your loyalty badge back. And Emmerich, thank you, Emmerich.
Where are you guys going? We go through all
the
maps.
I only have the first two unlocked. I had to reinstall the game.
Wait, you can't. Really? You can't vote for anything else.
I recently, or not recently, but a few months ago, I reinstalled my OS. So,
What are you going? What are you going left for?
You know, swim upstream or downstream, whatever the other fish don't do.
Sinvicta, thank you for the resubscription.
And thank you, Alaskan Savage, for the host as well.
Thank you, Alaskan Sinvicta, for the $20 donation.
Honestly, he would never make it in Alaska. Too many chicken wings.
Dude.
Oh, yes. Yeah,
you need to watch Man Eater, Ryan, if you're all about the...
It's called Meat Eater. You keep calling it Man Eater and making it...
Whatever. Some people might say that the premise of it is really about how hunting meat eats eater. Him up inside.
What?
You bite the fry bites back, my man.
Damn. Oh, God.
From beyond the grave. I'm not gonna watch. I don't watch enough to watch a TV show that has like 15 seasons.
It's only. You only need to see two seasons.
That's a lot of television.
It's not.
You're giving me like a 20 hour job.
You said there's 80 episodes?
No.
Of Maneater?
There's like 10 episodes, maybe a season. Maybe it's probably.
How many seasons are there?
Well, there's only 5 and 6 on Netflix, so do what I did. Huh?
I don't know. He's never answered.
That's good, man. He kills a grizzly.
Wait, by himself? Man,
why?
Why is he killing grizzlies for?
He's a hunter. Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty rude.
No, maybe he just talked about killing a grizzly.
He's all talk, no action, is what you're saying.
Grizzly meets all grizzle. I don't want
Well, I mean, they show you, like, they go to Alaska or British Columbia or something, and they're just like, last time we came here, we were here for a week, and we didn't even see a grizzly. So,
I mean, I've been living here for, like, 4 years, and I've never seen a grizzly, so.
Nick saw a grizzly once.
No, I saw a black bear. It's different.
Yeah, way different. One will kill you, one will just make you shit yourself.
Black bears are friendly?
Oh, I mean,
they're not friendly, but they're not as likely to be as aggressive.
I didn't know that.
I also didn't know that.
Polar bears will mess you up, though.
I mean, have you seen a bear?
Me? Yeah.
I mean, they're like, they're real muscly.
They're pretty intimidating, because they're
actually,
very heavy.
Have you seen one without its fur? They're actually pretty flabby.
Oh, I don't think it's like flab, though.
There's muscle under there, but there's also a lot of
flab. Have you ever seen like a human being?
You're not thinking that way.
Like, we're... Oh, my God, you fuckers.
Get fucked.
Oh, no.
Oh, I'm not last.
Like, we're so lucky that we're really, really smart relative to the rest of the animal kingdom. Like, it cannot be overstated that if you put, like, me, a chimpanzee, and a grizzly bear in the same room, I'm going out first. Like, I'm hey, let's make an alliance. Let's collude. Oh, you know, like, I'm going to be dead in 2 seconds. But if you put us all in a room and had, like, an IQ test, I would smoke the shit out of them. It would not even be close.
You might have the sense to not engage the bear as fast as the chimpanzee.
If you put me and a chimpanzee and a grizzly bear in a locked room, there is no way I'm getting out. What am I going to do?
You're getting out second, or you're not getting out second as well.
What am I going to do? I'm going to, like, smith a gun inside of the room from the...
No, I'm just saying the chimpanzee might die before you. That's all.
I have old age. What about an orangutan? You guys think
absolutely no. It would kill your ass dead.
I think I could wrestle.
You could, there is no, no you chance could. You could kill an orangutan. I'm just gonna like
I don't know about kill, but I can maybe
you see what it did to that lady's face,
dude. If you want to like have a one-on-one actual fist fight with an animal, we need to choose an animal that weighs like under 50 pounds for humans to have a chance.
You think so?
They're all muscle and they kill to survive.
Yeah, there's some animals though that you just have to know the right technique.
Yeah.
Like if it's a snake and you know how to grab it, you're not as in as much danger if you know that one trick.
Yeah, no, but a snake weighs like 3 pounds, unless it's like
snakes
a fucking.
All kinds of sizes of snakes, man. You don't know that.
Well, yeah.
What
if
about
you go
up... an anaconda?
Would you want to go up against the anaconda?
I would.
Want none.
I'll kill it. Bare hands.
If I had a knife and a snake was trying to get me, I think I could live.
You don't have a knife. That's
Yo,
the whole
you're not
point.
Win against a cobra.
Gabe, if you put me in the, you know, like a bunker and gave me a machine gun, I could probably take out a bunch of animals as well.
You think you could? You think you'd aim with the machine gun? Oh, I pressed the wrong button, sorry.
0% chance I could not kill, like, if there was like a D-Day landing of like crocodiles and I was in one of the bunkers on like Juno Beach, there is no doubt I would kill at least a few crocs before they got in.
Would you rather have a machine gun, though, or a handgun? I think I'd be better with a handgun.
I would absolutely rather have a machine gun. Are you crazy?
I'd rather have a shotgun.
What are you talking? Are you going to shoot these crocs from, like, a kilometer away with a fucking shotgun?
No, I think Rob is actually right.
Yeah.
Shotgun?
You want to have a
control weapon.
Spread. Okay.
Yeah, that's why, you know, in World War I, they're like, hey, disassemble all the bunkers. Everybody gets a shotgun now.
Attack you from a distance.
Exactly. Yeah, that's about having range. You know, that's.
You should have way more range against a crocodile because a crocodile can't do shit to you up close.
All right. As somebody who's recently watched Meat Eater, they talk about the versatility of shotguns in killing big game and small game. So I would take the shotgun.
Look at London 2012.
Guys,
think of all the clay pigeons
actually,
you slaughtered.
The thing I will also say is video games do not portray shotguns effectively. Mostly because, like, if a shotgun was portrayed as it actually is in the situations that you're shooting guns in a video game, they'd be way too effective. Yeah.
Yeah.
They blow holes in things all the way through.
Why in the world? Okay.
That big, and they have a much longer range.
Yeah, okay, awesome. It's a freaking, it's a D-Day invasion. You're going to be like, hey, Jim, a lot of crocodiles landed on the beach today. Do you want to, like, take shots at them now? Or do you want to wait until they get close enough to strike, and then, you know, we'll just hit them all with our shotgun?
You don't need to be close with the shotgun. That's the point,
You
though.
Don't need to be close at all with the fucking machine gun. It shoots like
you need to be accurate.
It shoots like 15,000 bullets per minute.
Give me a bolt action rifle, I'll do just fine.
I
don't know about bolt action.
This is why you guys, when the inevitable World War III happens, you guys are going to be privates and I'm going to be a fucking lieutenant.
Don't,
but if it's like crocodile apocalypse, we'd deal with that in like 5 seconds. Like, that wouldn't be very difficult at all.
I was born in
what
nature.
These people have like a big hard-on for shotguns. I'm not insulting shotguns. I'm just
you
saying.
You are, though.
I'm not. I'm just
you
saying
are.
If there was like.
Characterizing them.
If there was a bevy of crocodiles, I would much rather have a fucking machine gun than. Like, we're talking about like a mounted heavy machine gun instead of like one dude with a 12 gauge.
I mean, a mounted heavy machine gun.
When
yes,
I said the D-Day
probably.
Invasion, was that not the first thing that came to your mind?
Machine gun implies, like, submachine gun, like an Uzi or something. How does a machine gun...
M4 or something.
What are you talking about, you fucking...
I don't want an M4 against a bunch of crocodiles.
Yeah, I don't want an M4. Yeah.
You guys are out of your fucking mind.
No, Ryan.
All right, how about this?
How about this?
Best of both worlds, AA-12, an automatic shotgun.
Well, let's just get a fucking bazooka at this point.
That's true. If we have any choice, you know.
Their heart.
Just hate you.
Like,
Second Amendment fucks.
All you take is one shotgun shot to the top of a croc.
Yeah. Okay. What if you have 1,000 crocodiles?
Okay. You know
what?
Great sentence. You get like 10 feet up and you shoot down.
What do you mean you get 10 feet up? You're gonna like jump really high and
jump a bit if they're in water, but
oh, they death roll.
I don't know if they jump, really.
No, like, they can basically jump up out of the water. You know, when you see them, they hang, like, a skinned rabbit over the water, and they kind of, like... But if
they have tremendous
ground,
upper body strength.
They're on ground, they can't really do much.
I'm just saying I want stopping power, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Great.
I want to feel like a big man with a shotgun.
Like, when Jules and Vince you know, are talking about what they want when they go up to the room with three guys. They don't say they should have given us a machine gun. They say they should have given us a shotgun.
You gotta say Vincent. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, all right, fair enough. I'm just saying.
Yeah, but they're also, you know, $10 says Ryan goes to shoot the first croc and he's surprised by the recoil and ends up like shooting the shit the ceiling. And then
yeah.
Well, I just don't know what you guys are doing for the first like 20 minutes of this like crocodile invasion, where like crocodiles are just pouring in on the beach and you're just gonna be like, all right, well, I gotta wait until they get like 200 feet away.
No, what you're gonna do is you're gonna stay there and kill them all. We're just gonna like kind of saunter off and climb a tree.
You guys are done.
I mean, if you get to choose a heavy machine gun, then I get to choose an AA-12.
It doesn't bother me at all. This doesn't bother me in the least.
I'm choosing an airstrike.
I know shotguns have range. You guys all invest in like big shotgun or something? I'm not trying to insult the range of shotguns. Range. Machine guns also have range.
I mean, you changed the rules of the situation.
I did not. I specifically said it's a D-Day. I said if I was in a D-Day situation on Juno Beach.
All right, then turn it in the other direction. I want a sniper rifle. I want to sit up in a tower where the crocodiles don't even know I am.
Why would you not want a machine gun, though, instead of a sniper rifle?
I don't even have to get close. Shoot them.
I just want to have a locked door. They can't really deal with doors very well.
With a sniper, you can see when the crocs are coming from like a mile away.
Yep. That's at least. And you get target practice, too.
Oh, cool.
You know what, Ryan? Okay, guys. When we're in a real life scenario of survival, I elect that we just kill Ryan right away and eat him. He's just gonna weigh us down with this gun.
I mean, yeah, this is gonna be a problem if we're trying to make a quick decision and you gotta like drag it out like this.
Yeah, you know, why go with the objectively right answer when we could talk it out and then come to a suboptimal answer later?
How would you even know what objective is? None of us have been in this scenario before. And I'm gonna reckon most of us have probably not fired anything more than an air gun.
I've shot a shotgun, actually.
Yeah, so that's...
Oh, so he's a resident expert. You guys are all high as hell.
You guys never shoot a shotgun? It's real fun, actually.
NL, do you still think we'd win the IQ test? That's a great question.
I love when chat finishes the joke for us.
Why did on D-Day? Why didn't they all just get up real high with a sniper rifle and shoot all the allies as they landed?
Oh, why didn't they do that?
They had a lot of shots.
Why didn't they just use a freaking bazooka?
I mean, I'm just saying, you change the rules throughout half the thing.
Didn't
you know,
change
right?
The rules.
Why didn't they do that?
So you got a machine gun, not a you know an LMG.
I said a mounted machine gun, like a Juno Beach sort of situation. You're not picturing, you know, you're not picturing like a Nazi in a bunker holding a Tommy gun, like shooting down into the sand.
High-powered handguns would be a good way to go if you need penetration. Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
Don't even
a
give me this.
A desert eagle would fuck up a crocodile.
But it's not a crocodile. It's like 1,500 crocodiles.
Yeah, that's true. That's why shotguns
are
best.
Then think about ammo then, and think about
the
how
ammo is light,
reload.
It's powerful.
Shotgun's gonna take you a bit to reload. Pistol's a lot faster. Machine gun's probably equally fast.
A pistol's not going to have the stopping power that either a machine
There's
gun
plenty
or
of pistols
a shotgun
different.
Yeah, unless you have like a Magnum or
something. This conversation is actually making me mad now. we've hit like peak irony where I'm like, no, we can't talk about this anymore.
All right, what about
use a slingshot? Then you don't even need bullets, and you know, back in the Roman times, you've seen the David versus Goliath story. You could take down a freaking giant with those things.
I tell you what, you can't have a mounted machine gun. What do you choose?
Am I still in a bunker?
No, you're right on the beach. There's
I'm
no
on
no
the beach.
Protection. Yeah. You're right in the sand.
Crocs
There's
are,
nothing
crocs are
in any direction for half a mile.
At that point, I would probably want a shotgun, I guess.
Yes.
Right. You know?
We won, boys.
We all agree.
I mean, that makes sense. Or like a fucking flamethrower. Something like that, if we're being ridiculous.
They don't feel pain.
Crocodiles don't feel pain.
They got thick scales.
They'll just keep walking while they're on fire. They don't give a shit.
Flamethrower would be pretty dope.
I actually like really don't like the idea of flamethrowers.
Well, they are against the Geneva Convention now.
An awful, awful thing to do to someone.
How so?
You know what should be against the Geneva Convention? Killing other people.
Yeah, probably.
Would you much rather be shot than burned to death?
Yeah, I'd much rather like not be shot though. If we're gonna take that out,
that's true. I'd
still rather be shot in the stomach than burned to death.
Well, yeah, but you don't get to choose, right?
You get to choose if the flamethrower is off the table. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I think guns should be off the table too.
Wait, and, so you have like knife or
yeah, you just like your fists or something like that.
So somebody's gotta like walk up to you and gore you with a blade.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, I'll take a knife over fists any day of the week, really.
What about brass knuckle fist though?
That's even worse. You guys ever with get hit spikes. In the head with something with hard, like hit something heavy?
No.
It's a fuck.
Where do you live?
Well, I mean, come on, we're all aware of these.
I've been hit with a baseball. Does that count?
Yeah, like I've been hit in the face with a baseball, but that's
like
about
traveling
it.
At a good.
Yeah, velocity. Well, your face is killing
pretty
me.
Pretty painful, honestly.
Yeah, it's shitty. It sucks.
I mean, it sucked. It just made my nose bleed. You get back out like 15 minutes later.
Yeah, hit in the nose.
That you got hit in the face feeling like I got hit in the face basketballs no. all the time. Never got used to that feeling.
Yeah, getting in the face sucks. I'm just saying, never get hit in the face with a beer bottle, because it sucks.
How'd you get bottled?
You get into fights, you know, it happens.
That's too much, man.
They're made out of sugar glass in the movies.
Yeah, no, they don't break, actually. Like, they straight up, like, you can bash a guy in the face several
times.
Yeah,
you can actually, like, murder somebody.
Yeah. Like, they're made of some durable glass.
They have to go through shipping.
Yeah.
Shipping's a strenuous process for most.
Yeah, I'm just saying, you know, you ever think about having a bar fight and you think of picking up a bottle? No, that's like assault with a deadly weapon, yeah. Baby. Don't do it.
Anytime I've gotten to the state where I was like, this is going to be a fight, I've been like, let's just leave this fucking bar. This is the stupidest shit of all time. I'm going to get in a fight with some dude in a bar because he like sits weird on his chair and he's taking up my leg room.
Because of his forearms.
Yeah, mainly because of his forearms. I mean...
They're like the way he looks at you.
Ryan almost started a fight with Maya when she tried to help him and put sunscreen lotion on him.
Why would you do that?
That doesn't seem right.
No, it did. You guys were here. We're going to go to Canada's Wonderland, and she was going to help you, and then he raised his fist.
I didn't raise my... Come on.
Oh, my God. Jesus.
I hope this didn't happen.
No, you didn't close the fist. It was more like an open hand.
He was gonna open
Maya? I don't know what world like some people live in. They always like they're talking about fights all the time. Like I was walking down the street with Kate and I was wearing my Twitch hoodie, and then like some young guys were coming in the other direction. One of them went, "Woo, Twitch!" And then Kate was like, "That was me. I would have fought him." I'm like, what for? It's not.
She's just trying to show you what you should be doing.
It's like,
was
you know...
Was PAX when we were walking back to the hotel? Because I vaguely remember being
no,
there.
No, this was like 2 weeks ago.
Oh.
And then, like...
Even better.
You should have
like,
fought
him. They might have meant it as, like, a sign of disrespect. Or maybe they didn't, and, like, either way, I'm not gonna, like,
yeah,
go
bleed,
to jail.
Yeah, nerd!
I'm not gonna, like, go to jail because some dude is, like... You know, anti-Twitch or something like that.
I mean, he could. I don't know. There was a period.
Oh, God. He got a bad sunburn. Kate put lotion on his arms, and Ryan fucking froze and got uncomfortable.
They don't think I'm an easy guy to pick on just because they.
Punch their face to know you're manly man.
I don't know what kind. You guys live.
Show your T count off.
You guys live in a world. Yeah, it's a really good decision to punch the dude in the face, and then you get, like, a criminal record, and you owe them, like, $15,000 because you punched...
I mean, if he's a reasonable dude, you know, you can accept a loss of a fight if you lose or if you win. You don't have to bring the cops into it.
But, like, we should, right? Like, that's... No. If a dude punched me in the face, I would get the cops involved in, like, 2 seconds.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely! I'd be like, this dog punched me in the face. It's illegal.
I mean, yeah. If you're a bitch.
What do you mean? You guys...
Check these cars, Ryan.
You guys live in a weird, like, 1950s world, man.
Be your own cop.
I mean, I will say, there's a period in my life when it was much more susceptible to getting into fights and starting fights. Now I feel like I'm... more of a conflict resolver than a conflict starter, but, you know, still. If somebody comes at me, I'm gonna fucking.
We didn't come at me though. He just said woo Twitch.
That's not bad at all.
He might have been a fan or something. And imagine that news story. You know, like
somebody, Ryan Fights fan
did that to me. I'd just be like, yay, a fucking internet.
He would do that.
And then you keep walking.
Absolutely.
I would do that too. Like, but what if he like said something like real fucked up?
Like what?
You or Kate?
You're a little.
Don't make me.
Yeah. Like what? Like we're an interracial couple, Rob. I'm sure you can think of something.
Come on.
Wow, Rob, racist.
Oh my god.
Wow, Rob.
But imagine somebody says some shitty thing. What are you gonna do? You're not gonna pop him in the face?
I'm not gonna pop him in the face. No.
Why not?
Nah.
Because I don't want to go to jail because I'm. It would be the worst to, like, be in jail and also, like, be right. Like, if you're in jail and you're wrong, you'd be like, yeah, I get it, you know? I drove drunk or something. If you're in jail and you're right, you're like, this is a grave injustice. That dude should go to jail.
I've been to jail. It's not a big deal.
That's actually true, and that's what it bothers me the most.
Who's more the, like, chaotic one? Is it gonna be Rob or Kate?
I feel like Kate would have my back if I, you know.
I mean, she would, but she wouldn't be in there, like, throwing punches with you. She'd just be telling you to throw the punch.
Yeah,
so,
that's all right. You know, it's the moral support that I need.
You'd really be the one in jail, and she'd be like, yeah, that was a really good idea, because it was funny.
You know what? I tell you what. I have been arrested before. Never have I been arrested or in any trouble with the police over fighting. That's never happened. I've been in a good deal of fights.
I think, like, America was a mistake. You guys are just fighting each other for no reason all the time.
I mean, sometimes are you kidding me, Laser?
It's like you gotta go out for a rip and it's like, fucking buddy came over and I punched him, right? And it's like, Canadians fight all the time too, but in a good-natured way.
No, like, townies fight.
I mean, hockey is your sport of choice.
Yeah, we're trying to get rid of fighting in it.
Wow.
Are you becoming British now?
Enforcers have, you know, it's a role that's becoming deprecated.
I still feel like, you know what? Even if you get rid of fighting, it doesn't mean it's going to be some giant sissy sport. You still got checking and all that stuff.
Still hitting each other, like, all the time.
Yeah, if anything, that makes it seem, like, even better when somebody gets a good hit. You're like, oh, they rocked this world! They're thinking of better ways of getting them without actually getting them, you know?
The discussion over fighting I also find is like a pseudoscience. People go like, yeah, you know, when your team's losing, sometimes you just need a momentum shift. And I'm like, hey, what is a momentum shift in sports? You fight, you punch a dude in the face and then they go, well, we're up 3-0, but you beat us up, so.
They feel demoralized.
I can see some, I mean, what's the science between, like, home games and away games, right? Like, there's the crowd, there's, like,
time zone,
building morale and all that.
You know.
I think it makes
a
difference.
Or in hockey, the sixth man? How many, was it hockey 5-on-5?
It's 5-on-5.
We don't really call it
regular play.
Yeah. You should.
I mean, can't say America was a mistake now. I don't like this.
You know, unironically, I actually agree that hockey should kind of remove the fighting because it does kind of make it look really unprofessional.
Can they just branch it off into a different sport then?
It's called boxing.
Yeah, I think that sport may already exist.
You mean boxing on ice?
I want them to slide around and fight. I like that idea.
Hockey fights also, like, 99% of them just suck. Like, every once in a while you get, like a heavyweight fight, and most of the time it's just, like, one dude punches another dude 8 times in the face and you feel really sad.
I thought they, like, sever each other's corroded arteries with their blades.
Nah, that's been outlawed for a while.
Did you
probably
know
a good thing.
Hockey and lacrosse used to be played with human skulls? It's
pronounced LaCroix.
Pronounced Michael A. LaCroix.
Oh my god, I gotta smoke this box.
No, seriously, they used to play hockey and lacrosse with human skulls.
Punctuation of
their enemies.
On all of that is just, you know, sometimes you gotta resort to fisticuffs, man.
I don't
all
think
I'm
so, though.
What if somebody decks you in the face?
Well, then I'll, you know, call the cops, get sent to jail.
No, you choke them out.
If he keeps decking you in the face.
Well, at some point you gotta defend yourself. I agree. But if a dude just like pops you in the face and then like goes away, I'm not gonna chase him down, and punch him in the face. I'm gonna call the cops.
Yeah.
What if he took your wallet, would you chase him down?
I'd probably try, yeah. There's a lot of
You've seen ghosts though, right?
I have not seen Ghost, but I've read the Wikipedia synopsis. So,
so you know what happens sometimes.
Yeah, you gotta make clay with your former lover.
You gotta make clay as a ghost. You gotta make
clay.
Have you seen I Am Wrath?
I have not seen I Am Wrath.
Honestly, like, at first I was like, I don't know why I'm gonna watch this, but I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was bad. It was so good, though. It was so good, and it was bad.
You're all about that I Am Wrath.
Wow. He's like,
you just gotta make clay.
Goldie, who are you? Goldie, thank you as well. I'm just amazed at how many people out there. I gotcha!
What are you doing?
I'm amazed at how many people out there have nothing to lose. Like, a fight is totally fine if you got nothing to lose. And you're like, man, oh, if I spend the next, like, 2 days in jail, that's fine. You know? Wasn't doing anything anyway.
I mean, it's not, you know, you really, like, I don't know. Maybe it's different. Like, now that I'm an older gentleman, perhaps,
like,
perhaps, like, now, if I get into a fight with a person of similar age, it might end with, like, the police. But, like, when I was getting into fights, which was, like, junior high, high school, college, like, it was just like, yeah, you got in a fight, you know, you get a little bloody, you learn a little bit more about yourself and each other.
There's culture around that when you're a kid. Yeah. Once you're older, though, it's, like, kind of weird to fight somebody.
Yeah.
It's a signal that something is, like, wrong. If you get into, like, one fight in your life, you could see, like, yeah, that some dude was being an asshole and I fought him. If you've been in, like, three fights as an adult, you're probably the asshole.
You're looking for fights.
Yeah.
I mean, there is that culture of, like, you know, looking for fights.
I mean, yeah. Like, admittedly, I haven't had a fight since I was, I don't know, probably, like, 20. So it's been a while. Maybe 22. There was that one time.
I never had, like, traditional fights. Basically, people would pick on me because they thought they could pick on me. So I would just, like, crank it to 11 and just straight up punch them in the face.
Nice.
And I mutually think assured a lot destruction. Of the time that shocked them too much.
Yeah, shocking so them. Didn't, I know that move.
They didn't know how to react, and they'd just be, like, almost, like, offended. They're like, fuck, he punched me. So then I didn't have to, like, actually fight, you know? It was a very ballsy move that almost went sour a couple times, but early
it
on
can backfire really bad.
You don't mess with the fox, man. You just don't.
You get the paws.
Plus, I think people would feel bad about, like, really just giving it to me because I'm not a big guy.
That's a good point. Yeah,
alpha mouth malpha. Yeah.
I just feel like people are, like, you know, live in, like, the animal kingdom or something like that. We don't live in the animal kingdom anymore, and it's, like, real dope that we don't. It's, like, because it just goes, like, 0 to 100 too fast. Like, you hear these stories, like, oh, why'd you fight that guy? I didn't like the look he gave me.
He was the best hot dog shooter in the Southwest.
The only time I ever picked a fight myself was when somebody made, like, a crack about me as I was walking down the street. Mm. And then I turned around, and we had a bit of a shouting match. We were both very drunk. And then I punched him in the face, and we got into a fight in the street. But that's the only time I ever started a fight. Other fights, you know, I just defended myself.
I was at a party in university once, and it was, like, crazy crowded, like, fire code violation. The guy behind me was like, yo, bro, can you move a little faster? And I was like, yo, bro, I'm moving as fast as I can. And then we kind of had, like, a little bit of a staring match to some extent. And then he was like, all right, we'll see, buddy. And then the host of the party was like, don't mess with that guy. He has a knife. And I was like, that's what I'm going to get killed over. It's crowded. He asked me to move, and I couldn't move. So now I'm dead. Like,
when being Canadian goes wrong.
That's like at Stages in Kingston. That one guy accidentally, like, bumped into the other guy at the bar, like, counter, and he pulled out a knife and stabbed him in the neck.
Yeah,
oh,
maybe, like,
what? In the neck?
All right,
maybe this would mean more if you knew that Fox and I grew up in a town where, like, there's a stabbing per year at one of the six bars in the city. So
yeah, I mean, that's pretty bad. I've never really, I mean, one the guy had a ring on and he gave me a scar above my
eye. One guy had oregano?
Yeah, he got some oregano, yeah. He just, like, threw oregano out of his pocket into my eyes and just hit me a couple
tried
times.
Tried to spice dust you.
I had a couple rings on and a scar over my eye from it, but it's the only weapons that I've ever... Well, and a beer
in the neck. I can't get over that.
That's pretty fucked. You gotta that's be pretty mad to kill somebody in the neck.
Well, yeah, he succeeded in his intent as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I knew a guy who's in jail forever because he bashed a guy in the head with a hammer and killed him.
Who would have thought that that would be enough to sever the human form?
Yeah.
Some people really actually, underestimate the capacity of the human skull.
Yeah.
I have a similar story, actually, to your knife thing. One time, I was playing handball, the New York-style handball, which is like...
That's a story. Not everything needs to be New York-style, well, no, right? No, if we're talking about a bagel, I'll give you that one.
Just enjoy the story. It's
let's play a New York baseball, you know?
No, I mean, but like, when I say handball, what do you think of?
I actually don't think of anything because I don't know what...
Baseball?
I don't know the rules of handball.
You're probably Olympic handball, right?
Yeah.
It's like some Scandinavian bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. Not that. It's the one that you see in prison movies where they hit a ball against the wall.
Oh, red ass.
Oh, yeah, wall ball.
Yeah. Wall ball.
Yeah, well, yeah, right, sure.
Oh, or as we called it in school, New York style handball.
It was just called handball. We say, yeah, go play handball, go play some handball.
Hey, chums, you want to get together and play some New York style handball?
Anyway, I was playing handball with this dude named Hector. I don't remember his last name.
Salamanca.
He was you know, there were like rumors that he was affiliated with gangs and the like.
In junior high.
Yeah, in junior high, yeah.
Didn't you go to like a school for the performing arts or something?
It was, well, yeah, in high school I did, yeah.
Oh, okay.
In junior high, it was like...
More like performing farts.
It looked like a prison. Yeah, I got him. Anyway, so we were playing handball. I was playing with this kid, Hector, and whatever. And, you know, we were having a nice, friendly match. And then his friend on the side who's just sitting watching the game is like, yo, Hector, that's that N-word this guy. And he's like...
Just say that.
That's what he said. He said, he's like, oh, it's this guy, you know, whatever. And he's like, oh, shit, word? And then he grabs at his shorts, and I see through his shirt the outline of a gun.
Oh, I thought you were gonna say his dick.
Yeah, no, just like pulls his dick out. Yeah,
starts jerking
that
off.
Guy,
just like jerking off the court. No, I see the outline of a fucking gun in his like, you know, he's just wearing shorts or whatever, and he's got a gun in his waist, and I'm just like. All right, so I'm gonna lose this match. I'm gonna go ahead and continue playing respectfully and lose. And then that's gonna be the last time I play with this guy.
It was in junior high.
Yeah,
it's like a Nos lyric, man.
Oh, somebody also pulled out a gun at my junior high, and that was pretty freaky.
It's amazing how much gun violence there is in the U.S.
Yeah,
it just happens a lot. I mean, that wasn't a case of violence, thankfully, but there was still
Yeah. But did he pull out his gun and then shoot that guy?
He didn't pull it out. No, he just grabbed at it at his waist.
For what purpose?
By assumedly to imply that his intention was to shoot this man. Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess that'll just do that.
Well, you know what? Why don't you guys give me some money, and myself and the rest of the dudes in the Malfia will protect you.
Yeah,
oh, you're still coming up with new ones to this day.
Oh yeah, every day.
A gun up
the Malfia bit was a great one too.
Please don't shoot up the place.
Wow.
Malfia male.
Some ladies tonight that should be having my baby.
Baby, Hardball is one of the best Keanu Reeves movies.
I would say it's definitely in like the top 30. You got the Matrix 1, John Wick, and it gets into like a little bit of a toss-up.
Excellent adventure.
I thought he was really good in Something's Gotta Give.
That's Jack Nicholson.
Jack Nicholson.
No, the golfer.
No, the golfer.
Jack Nicholas.
Anyone else feel like Christian Slater was just doing his best Jack Nicholson impression his entire career?
I prefer Atheist Slater.
I love him.
He's pretty good in that movie Mobsters that wasn't very good.
Pretty good in that movie Alone in the Dark that was really good.
Pretty good in that movie Nymphomaniac.
Was he a Nymphomaniac? I haven't seen that movie in a long time.
Got the pussy
it just came out like 6 years ago. How long could it be? You've been in a fight more recently than you've seen Nymphomaniac, man.
Yeah. Yeah, you're not wrong.
No.
No, I don't know. I mean, yeah.
I just remember the part where Willem Dafoe gets his dick bashed in with a screwdriver.
Is that the... There's that yeah. anecdote that, like, Willem Dafoe's dick is actually so cartoonishly huge that they had to use a yeah. smaller stunt actor?
I've heard that, videos. Yeah. I don't know if that's true.
He did, no, he did, like, a naked, like, Broadway kind of thing. He's just, like, wearing, like, these dirty white socks and his dick is waving around. Messed up.
That's life, man.
Fucking
that's
Reddit.
Where we all end up eventually.
You know, don't click links on Reddit. That's all I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, don't click.
Oh,
it
was Antichrist. Ah, same director.
Nymphomaniac, Antichrist, it's all the same.
Yeah.
Told you, yeah, 8 years later.
Really.
That's got to be, like, the most flattering thing to hear from a director. Even though, like, you know, obviously sizes and everything. But for the director to be like, come on.
Hey, Willem! Hey, Willem, your dick's too big!
Can we get someone with a smaller, like, average-sized cock in here right now? Sorry, Willem!
Acting.
The millionaire and revered Oscar winner Willem Dafoe also has a huge cock. Okay. Some people get all the luck. Sure, his face is a little weird, but...
Didn't we do this level already?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we did. We did,
definitely.
Why are we doing it again?
I don't know. Someone voted
I
for
can
it.
Only go on random.
Fox can so. Only vote for the first two levels.
No, I just go on random and it seems to work.
All right, let's do this. Let's do this, boys. Let's do
oh,
this.
Oh, shit.
All right, see you later. I can't believe Fox didn't hit it by accident.
You guys want to know a secret, not so secret Hollywood secret?
Sure, yeah. You please don't like out somebody. By the
no,
way,
no,
like,
no, 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 it's not, it's a not so secret.
Not that we'd get scooped by TMZ or something. It just seems like bad form.
We might. But it depends on this sometimes.
I could give you names of the people that I learned this from, but I'm not going to.
Yeah, don't
but,
do that.
Yeah. So, but you know, like whenever there's, whenever a dude's gotta like show dick, in a movie or something. Well, not maybe not whenever, but I mean, like you know. It happens, at least. Sometimes they'll just take like half a Viagra so that they're just like half chub, a little bit engorged for the camera.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah.
Why is that surprising?
Yeah, why wouldn't
it? It's not surprising. It's secret, not so secret, Hollywood secret.
You keep saying not my... so, and I think you're going to say it's a secret Nazi thing, and I don't like that.
Yeah, it's a secret Nazi secret. They use Viagra.
Frogs, bullies, thanks for the subscription. Pumpkin Scrubs, boys.
God, Rob is stupid.
Wait, that's not that's stupid.
It's literally, like, I mean, again, I could give you the exact name of the actors who told me this from a show.
Why would it? It's not like. I don't think anybody's going to doubt you.
Yeah.
Yeah there well, there's a lot of people in chat who will.
I mean, it's not like the Viagra is making your dick bigger. It's
no,
just
it's
like.
Just, it's giving you a little half chub, so it looks like
why not,
you're
bigger
that's
compared
size.
To not engorged.
Yeah,
yeah, but it's not like it's like doubling the size of your erect penis.
Yeah, it's just making it look like your resting size is larger than
exactly.
it actually is, which is what the intention is there, really.
Like, you don't want to be like in a movie and then people are like, look at that guy's baby dick.
Right, yeah. Super Troopers.
Well, yeah. I don't think he really cared in that.
Just tuck a cucumber in there or something, right?
No, that was fun.
Not if they're showing the dick, then it'd just be a big old cucumber.
Oh, yeah, okay. Forgot they were showing it. I thought it was just implied.
CGI it.
Mr.
Honestly.
Sleeps.
Yeah, like, I have big dog on somebody.
They did in, like, Spartacus. There's this one episode, this guy had, like, a foot-long dick. And then they cut it off.
Oh.
Well, wasn't that thing where, like, in Ghost Rider... Nicolas Cage spent like 6 months toning his body. So that
yeah, what an idiot.
No, but so that he could be like super ripped for the movie, and then they
he's
it turned
on fire
out
the
like...
whole time.
No, but like, and then he got pissed off because they just CGI'd his body instead. Just looked like an old.
Whoa! It's like, you know,
yeah,
Nicolas.
But...
We're gonna CGI. You're a fiery skeleton in this movie. Like, you should keep yourself in good health, but it's not that relevant. Oh.
Oh.
I'm you not, ever see those fake dicks in Game of Thrones? And you're like, what are they doing? Those don't look anything like the deal.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what? How do they make them look so bad?
You know.
Maybe they want them to look fake, so you go, oh, that's not his real dick.
I'm sure there's some weird dicks out there.
No, it's the way they move just doesn't... It looks like silicone.
They show moving dicks in that show?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, they show moving dicks.
How are they moving? Like up and down?
Side
like
to side, wagon. Mostly.
Side to side?
Well, South Park,
you know, when
us,
a dick
kind of
sways. You never moved your dick, Ryan?
No, I don't move it side to side that much. Like a windshield.
No, when you walk, it kind of sways.
The truffle shuffle. You never done that? And then.
The thing is, like, it'll move a little. But if we're talking real deal, like, it usually doesn't move much. And in these movies or shows, it moves a lot.
Why
and that's
are they
the
using
giveaway.
Fake dicks when all the ladies are showing their real nips?
Hodor.
Oh, Cersei didn't.
Yeah,
there
some
are
some
real dicks, but they gave Hodor like a 14-inch cock.
Yeah.
He deserved it, to be honest.
They did. He did have a prosthetic dick on.
And then when they like interviewed him about it or whatever, he's like, I really don't have a 14-inch dick. It's fake. In case you... Some people thought it was real.
I mean, we should have let them believe that it was a real penis.
It's too bright.
I would have. Anyway. Would you guys want a 14-inch penis, though?
Under no circumstances.
No.
Right?
That's like, far too large.
It's just,
I would.
It's unwieldy.
Why
it
would you want
a 14-inch?
Because I can always go down. I can't go up.
No, though. No. Like, that's a horrible reason.
You can get up surgery.
Reduction surgery.
I'm still really deciding why, but it's a terrible reason.
I mean, you can go up. You can go up by like an inch.
It's too dangerous. I'd rather go down than up.
Wouldn't you just rather be at like a good size and not have to have them slice off a piece of your cock?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, the thing is, like I don't think that there's a lot of like girls or even guys.
You don't think that there's all them girls?
All them girls. That's not actually in the tone of the song at all.
Yeah, I did it
right. Shut up,
there you go.
All them girls. There you
all
go.
Them girls.
Yeah. But there's not a lot that are like
all the 10% I could give away.
Penis.
Well, that's fair. Like if you have like a wizard who's going to perform the, you know, hysterectomy.
And I do. Yeah.
Well, I mean, if we're already going to have a wizard reducing the size of our imaginary penis, then why even get the 14-inch penis in the first place?
It's because it's a bargaining chip. You use it to give away for things.
Oh, right. For the, you give away a percentage of your dick for...
Yeah, exactly.
I get you.
Ooh.
Wow.
Sharky learned a shark. I just, like I feel like 10 inches is very large. 14 inches is comical. Like... That's like, and I'm not trying to, if you have
it's
a 14
just a failure of imagination if you think that.
If you have a 14-inch dick in chat, like, I'm not trying to insult you, but I'm going to say something that's pretty insulting. That's like circus level. Like, it's like Guinness Book of World Records.
Everyone's body is different, Ryan.
I'm not trying to shame them for it. I'm just saying, like, it's several, I believe, like, orders of magnitude away from the mean, which is fine. I'm just saying, like... It's not, the question is not like, would you like to have a large dick? It's like, would you like to have probably like the largest dick in your city?
I think so. With great power comes great responsibility, and some people can actually step up to that responsibility.
I mean, it does kind of give you like opportunities, right? Like if you have a 14-inch penis, you go right into porn probably pretty
easily.
Opens
doors for you immediately.
I don't think you could be anybody's favorite actor.
Just
though.
As you're about to walk in, the door will open.
But I mean, like, it's like you got a job on the table for like the rest of your life, probably.
I guess so.
Yep.
I mean, there are actual
imagine grandpa with 14-inch dick.
Yeah, I mean, like, you could even not even really work out if you had a 14-inch penis. Like, you'd just be a big fat guy and have a 14-inch penis.
So there's this guy who has a 14-inch dick and he's homeless because he can't get a job because his dick is too big.
No, that's not why. That's just a very convenient excuse.
I mean, a job in porn.
Yeah, sorry, can't get into college, my dick's too big.
After a while, all the girls are like, it's too big, it
sorry,
kills my
can
service.
You say that in Sean Paul's voice, though? After a while, all them girls!
Oh, Fun fact, the largest dick is 13.5 inches, so Raya won't insult anyone.
Yeah, yeah, so we're not even talking about, like, having a large one. Like, this is the largest, maybe, in human history.
Yeah, but there's, isn't that, I saw this documentary, or this YouTube documentary on this, it's like this white dude with a, like, a 10-inch soft... And every time he goes into the airport, he has like this special.
Inch soft.
Yeah, it's like this special process because they think he's smuggling flashlights or something down there. So he wears his special underwear, so they can like be like, all right, that's the outline of your dick. Yeah, you don't like. It's crazy.
Oh, yeah, fuck. Sounds like an awful. Yeah, it's probably pretty annoying.
I imagine it's it's like the. They always have those people on, like, documentaries that are like, ooh, I, like, got in a car crash, and ever since then, I have an involuntary orgasm every, like, 45 seconds. Everybody watching it, goes like, yeah, that sounds like a problem I'd like to have, and then they're, like, actually, like, I want to kill myself. And you're like, ooh, okay, that's,
That would be the worst. I mean, after, like, 3, it fucking hurts.
Everything in moderation, including moderation. If you have orgasms too much, you're not going to enjoy them anymore.
Yeah.
It would be sure. Like, yeah.
It's like Christmas.
It's gonna be like dick pain at all times.
It's like how I imagine Austin must feel about Chick-fil-A.
He's always... if you went to a bank where there's coins.
Like, I've eaten at Chick-fil-A once in my life, so I, like, respect the chicken sandwich. He's getting it, like, 3 times a week. It must just be dinner for him now. It's not even special anymore.
You can make your own at home.
I know I can make my own at home, Fox.
You make your own Chick-fil-A at home?
Just get some bricks and a mortar. $100,000 previous experience running a business, and then also political leanings that are in kin with the actual owners of the business.
You gotta hire staff, too. Juice.
Yeah, and pickle not juice. Give them health insurance.
Pickle juice, and then you put the chicken in it for overnight, and then you do your little, like, batter shit. It's all about the pickle juice. In,
turn yourself around.
I've been getting Subway twice a week for 2 years, and it's still as good every day. That's true. There's something about just, like, walking by a Subway, and they got that bread aroma, and I'm like, I'm in. Even if I just finished a sandwich, I'm like, you know what? You got me. I want another one.
What? About that
what? Nick,
marinara.
Nick, what? You dragged me up to the top? What the fuck is that?
I'm coming up with new ways to put your ass to sleep.
This bullshit. I know, Subway's all right.
Subway's alright, yeah.
Oh no.
Meatball marinara.
Like, I'll have a Subway. Like, if you offer me a Subway sandwich right now, I'd eat it. I ain't gonna go out of my way to get a Subway sandwich, though, right now.
You don't have to. They have more locations in North America than any other restaurant.
Wow.
In the world.
Wait, do they really?
True? Yeah.
More than McDonald's. Yeah, McDonald's is more profitable.
Really?
Wow, I really didn't know that.
Which,
I didn't know that either.
Yeah. Yeah. It's true. Well, all they need is a couple tins and put some, like, month-old deli meat in them with shredded lettuce.
Didn't McDonald's, like,
McDonald's! Didn't McDonald's! I's the man that sells it!
Diddle me lucky charm.
Oh, no.
McDonald's.
Didn't they at some point, like, become the largest real estate holder on Earth? It's McDonald's.
No, it's
McDonald Trump's.
McDonald Trump.
It's actually Donald Trump.
The joke is he's the next president, possibly, of the United States. Gold.
No, he's not. Stop.
I'm not kidding.
He's not.
538 has Hillary Clinton at a 69% chance today.
This is
very nice.
Oh, house rules, that's boys. Fantastic. House rules.
Yeah, that means she wins automatically, please.
No Look vote, no vote.
What? The ice gave you a baby. Huge advantage.
Slidey powers.
It's like a human skull on the ice.
Oh,
how'd you like that, dog?
Nice dip. Ooh.
This game's still real fun. I'm glad we played
this. Good game. We haven't played it in like a year, and the muscle memory is still there.
It was one of the ones that I would ask for every now, and they'd be like, definitely not. So I just kind of stopped asking.
Yeah.
Get those lights off. Get those lights off. It's so good. No, get those lights off! Get those lights off!
Get all of those lights off. It's a remix.
Why'd you just stand there?
I'm anti-hook technology.
Oh.
He doesn't have a hook! Where did the hook go?
I've had a hook this whole time!
You're imagining hooks now.
Pablo. Oh no.
Escobar?
Yeah, I like Pablo.
Oh!
Oh la la la! Come on, baby! Come on, baby! Nope, dodged!
Wow!
It looked like it said Duger.
What?
That hill is wild times. GG.
Flawless victory, flawless victory.
Easy, GG.
You guys want to run some ads, come back and play Quiplash?
Yeah, I'm down.
Nunrab13, thank you for the resub as well.
Duger.
Biddly-doop. I like that.
Yeah, it's a good sound effect.
Biddly-doop.
Salt peanuts. Hello.
That's from the cable guy.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, it's also the one song.
I want to ejaculate in Kobe.
That's nice.
Kobe.
I went like twice in 1 week.
Yeah, how did you feel the second time? Probably not as good as you felt the first time.
Just as good as the first
time. Ooh, that's how you know they got it.
First time.
It's like the Foreigner song.
You have Grubhub now, right?
I do. I ordered Thai last night. It was amazing.
Ooh, what'd you get?
It was like a yellow curry something or other. I don't know.
I don't even know.
And some spring rolls. It's good.
I'll have the cream of some young guy. What's your favorite Foreigner song?
Feels like the first time.
Oh, come on.
Feels like the very first time.
Feels like the first time.
Feels like the
very first time.
It's not my favorite anymore.
Feels like the very first time.
I really like, well, I don't like any Foreigner song, but if I had to choose one, I really like Urgent Emergency, because it's got that little, like, saxophone part where it goes like,
yeah.
You don't like your cold like as ice.
Would you say
they're as cold as ice?
I don't like cold as ice that much. I
got a fever of 103.
Hot Blood is okay.
It's good.
Oh, it's okay.
And then there's Jukebox Hero, and that's just...
I don't like Jukebox Hero.
What? That's the best one! I don't understand your taste in music at all.
What does it even mean to be a jukebox hero? He's like really good at using the jukebox?
He saw a band when he was young and he was like, I want to be like them one day. And then he did.
I don't like songs about becoming a musician. It's too inside baseball.
What?
It's too inside baseball.
We have a problem. I think the problem people were chasing their dreams. We all chased our dreams and now.
Yeah, but I don't like.
We're ordering Thai food at 8 p.m.
This is another really good Jackbox seed. I'll give it to you guys in a sec here.
You gonna give me your seed?
Yeah, well, let me just say that the answer to your question is the room code.
What? Is it yes with the two S's?
No, I'll give it to you on the Discord now.
I wanna see this.
Juice.
It's probably like, uh-huh.
Hero. I always thought it was Juicebox Hero.
Hey, what is Dan? Are you joining us for Quiplash?
Yeah, can
this
I?
This is the greatest news.
Oh, hey, Dan.
Please do.
He's asking. I told him to join.
All right, I'm gonna go to the bathroom first. Don't give the code out to stream. Don't give the code out to stream.
Guys, it's O.
Dan.
I didn't get in yet.
Juice. What's up, guys? How was the earlier portions?
They were good. That's like the most like. I didn't pay attention at all to anything in your life.
No, I click in and out. I'm a click in and out kind
of. Hey, Jill, how's, you know, your life? How's it been?
Your time of the month.
There's wow. All right, jeez.
That took too far.
Oh, what's up, Melfi?
Hey.
That was a lovely hey. That was, like, perfectly, like, staggered.
Hey. Hey, we go on. This is Jackbox.tv, right?
Yes.
It's been a while. I gotta get the rust off the old bicycle, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah. You gotta take the rust off of your mother.
This is a song.
Sandwich is out in the streets tonight.
Yeah, they're dressed as clowns. Haven't you heard?
Nick, do you draw during this segment? Do you still do that?
No, I'm doing 6v9 this time.
What's that?
It's an interactive Twitch game where they get to try and make boxes that beat each other.
Okay. I think I'm going to paint. I forgot this is
the one.
You
sounded so disappointed.
Well, your paintings were S tier. Isn't S tier above G tier?
I don't even know. G tier?
It's U tier. It's the ultra light tier.
B A S.
Yeah, well, your draw. When's the last time you did a drawing stream?
It's been a while.
Since I did a drawing stream right now. Hello.
Hey.
Which one of you guys is Juice Box Hero?
More sparkling water.
Do you have a fucking problem?
Yeah, I do.
I really do. What's your problem with sparkling water? It's delicious.
It's the can.
Yeah, why not drink it out of a can?
Instead of like what?
A bottle?
What's
Drink some.
I don't get sparkling water out of the freaking.
What is it about the sparkles you love so much, Fancy Boy?
They're delicious. Wait, have you ever had like a soda in your life?
Yes.
Yeah.
But it's also got like all sorts of flavor and bullshit. You know, I don't do it for the carbonation.
There's flavor in sparkling water, dog.
I do it for the carbonation.
Are you drinking flavored sparkling water?
Yes.
Sparkling water.
I have to admit, I am as well. Once you go flavored soda water, pop is kind of an apple.
What do you have in there, Dan?
I'm drinking a LaCroix.
What flavor?
Is it a can, boys?
Is it a pamplemousse?
God,
it's a pamplemousse.
How did you all talk so much at the same time? I thought a bunch of other iterations of the stream showed up in the background, repeating audio.
How do you guys feel about Orangina?
I don't like it at all.
I love it. That's
I like Orangina a lot.
No, it's the best. Big Orangina, fan. By the way.
Yeah, you're right.
What
I'm
about
sorry.
Orange Drinas?
I'm supposed to get my Orange Drinas soon.
Oh, Cammy TF in chat says LaCroix's not good, so sorry, Dan.
What?
They've just shattered our illusion.
I only drink LaCroix because of the can, I'm not even gonna lie.
It looks like a 1980s like tie-dye shirt or something.
What are you sipping on?
I'm sipping on a Dasani, because they don't sell LaCroix at my local grocery store.
They have flavored Dasani?
Yeah, this is lemon.
Yeah.
It's pretty special.
Yeah. Isn't that just lemonade?
No, there's no sugar in it.
Oh. Alright. So you're just simulating having a slice of lemon in your...
What are you talking about? It's like when you... I don't understand the problem.
High school Ryan would have kicked current Ryan's ass.
I don't think so. He would have been like, nice, zero calorie beverage. Do what you gotta do. This doesn't even have artificial sweetener in it. It's just water.
How much time is left?
23 seconds.
Melf, okay. Would you sit next to Ryan at lunch?
Starting in grade 10, I started sitting probably like 75% at that table.
Yeah.
What would Ryan's typical lunch be?
It was like turkey and mustard on whole wheat.
Did you just come with a sandwich? No, that's it?
Pretty much, and then when we went to Subway, he would get turkey.
Turkey and mustard on whole wheat. Slap casserole. The hardest question a bridge troll could ask you. What is the capital of Madrinas, or log of 5x minus 23 plus log of 7y plus 12 over AB2?
Yeah, I mean, that would be pretty difficult to work out, I think.
That's not a question, though. What's the question? That's just a command.
Solve for A.
It's that whole thing times B2. Let me through, bridge.
B2 or not B2, that is the question.
B2 or not B2, that is the question. Wow, Austin smoked this one.
With the log?
Yeah, it was like 80-20.
Trog, dog.
I can't believe I voted for what's the capital of Madrinas, and I was the only one.
That's a pretty good one.
It's your answer. A terrible thing to tell your kid when the dog dies. It's because you voted for Dance Party or Here's the Shovel.
Wow.
Jeez. That's some dark shit there, fellas.
Ooh, dark.
Here's the Shovel.
So you can bury it.
You gotta bury it.
So you can chop it up and Make it for dog stew later on tonight. Rob.
Wow.
It's too far.
Hey man, sometimes, you know, you didn't have a lot of money, you gotta eat the dog.
Chat has rebelled against Ultimate Chicken Horse memes. Yeah. Here's the shovel wins.
As soon as I saw a dance party, I was worried, man.
You guys ever had to put a pet to...
I'm not gonna talk about that on my show, Dan!
I'm not gonna talk about that because that ties into my third grade password.
You might want to talk to your child if he names his teddy bear Donald Trump or Cocksmith.
Wait, why don't you talk about losing a pet?
Dan, to answer your question...
It's a super downer, man!
No. I have my hamster named Fievel. He was sick on Christmas Eve, and by the time I woke up for Christmas, he was dead.
Wow!
I spent the night sleeping on the floor next to him.
So. Oh,
Dan, why are you laughing?
This is awful.
Laughing for
Cocksmith.
I was 8, so it was like tough, but I feel like it was a good time for. Like, it was a good time for that lesson to happen. You know, don't have that guy at Christmas.
This is so horrible. How can you tell? How you can tell that your toe is infected? Chick-fil-A is in your madrinas. Or when you fuck her with... I think it's supposed to be when you fuck her with the puss, but it says when you fuck her with the puss.
I think it's supposed to be with the puss.
When you fuck her with the puss?
I don't like either of those.
I'm gonna go ahead and no vote.
Is it like when you fuck, and then the person you're fucking is her with the puss?
It's
or is it...
to Zach and Mary make a porno. He's like, I want to fuck you in the puss.
Guys, oh. What has this become?
Somehow it won.
R-rated. We're like MC-17.
MC-17?
Master Chief 17.
The number one thing on Superman's bucket list. Bucket, or lifting that big island again, that was sweet.
I like bucket. It's a simple pleasure. By the way, join in if you want to play 6v9. All you have to do is type Team 6 or Team 9, and then you can start.
Don't do it in my chat, or Luke
Austin's
will ban
bucket,
you.
Huh? Bucket, and he's gonna win with Bucket as well.
You got a problem?
Luke? I do. Like, literally, that's like all of your fucking Quiplash.
Wasn't Luke like
a
quack rapper from the 90s?
That's Luke Perry. He was on Dawson's Creek or 90210.
No, Mr. Luke. He had like a very lewd rap video.
Mr. Luke was his name?
Yeah, something like that.
Sounds like he runs like a convenience store. Bucket smoked it there, by the way.
Yeah, that's not surprising.
Yeah,
really.
As well it should have.
Why am I even trying to have like any kind of Quiplash answers?
Bucky is a great answer. Get off your high horse.
The worst topping to put on a cake: a burger that's too tall or crabs.
What?
Burger that's too tall?
Because this is a reference to earlier.
If you weren't here for the first hour, you can't.
I'm going to go for crabs because I follow the religion of Christianity.
Christianity,
yeah. It's very important to me.
Christianity.
Oh, man. Oh, burger that's too tall actually won. Thank you, Chad.
You know what? Honestly, though, I would like a burger on top of a cake because I would just take the burger.
Are you all right? Are you transforming into an android in front of our eyes?
Hello?
Hey.
Nate.
Hey, bad? How's it going? Yeah.
Discord likes to do that sometimes.
That was scary, man. Especially after we've talked about all this robot stuff.
I'm stealing your passwords.
Ooh, I am SB2, thank you for the Twitch Prime subscription.
You're right there, Dan?
Yeah. Look how good this game was. All you do is you type in a sentence and it's funny.
To be a jukebox user.
Thank you, Zikachu and Vegetable Splatter. Or Vegetable Platter, rather. That's a bit of an odd one to mistake there. But thank you to both of you for the resubscriptions. I'm going to read all the rest afterward.
You think Vegetable Splatter is what they call it if there's a vegan bukkake?
Yes. Yes, they do.
I'll bring the vegetable splatter, you bring the cups.
This is... What's today, Wednesday? Wednesday is the unrated version of
Wacky Wednesday.
Red Band.
My chat was telling me what you guys were talking about at the beginning of this episode. Is that true?
Do you have anything to add to that conversation?
Thing to do at the grocery store when no one is looking. Swap the applesauce with bleach or put a Fuji apple in the Red Delicious bin.
Oh.
Got him!
That is 100% Ryan's.
Niners on fire. Thank you as well. How do you know that?
You're the only one who's gonna. You've been riding on Red Delicious and Fuji and all the apples forever.
Yeah, I love a Fuji apple. It's good for juice. It's good for eating. It's good, you know. It's round. It's robust.
Fuji is good. I like a Royal Gala though.
Ah, they're all right.
Yeah. Give it to me.
Hey Nick.
Yeah.
Give me something to draw. I'll draw it for you.
Draw the Joker from Batman.
Fuji right. Apple has won with a quiplash.
Oh, come on.
The weirdest gift you could give somebody... The weirdest gift you could give somebody is a pillow with a picture of their balls on it, or a pillow with a pillow on it.
Well, it's just like a stack of pillows, then.
The weirdest gift you give somebody is a pillow with pillow on it.
Yeah. Gift? The weirdest gift you could give somebody. That joke is the entire premise of Kristen Wiig's character in Zoolander 2.
That joke is the entire premise of the NLSS on Monday.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Hey,
wow. Ooh,
oh, please stop.
A picture of their balls wins.
Why did she spell her name with two I's? I feel like that breaks all grammatical rules in the universe.
That's a name. It doesn't have
to.
Yeah,
exactly. Why do you spell your name with two E's?
Yeah, and an H.
Could just be Dan Gesling. The worst thing a history teacher could say. You're a very good bad student, or the Earth is 6,000 years old.
I'm voting Earth is 6,000 years old at a principal.
I'm gonna take you to the principal.
don't do it.
My god, he roasted your ass. What's the Quiplash room again?
It's in the Discord.
Yeah, I just forgot.
Bazooka Tooth, thank you as well. The Earth is 6,000 years old wins. Fonks, don't try to meme when you don't even know the meme.
Have you seen the video now?
I didn't know what to put, honestly. So.
The best way to escape the inside of a whale. Fill it with Diet Coke and Mentos Pablo. Or get out of the whale.
Alright.
How did none of you say run all the way to the end until you're pooped out?
You can't just sign a Quiplash, Dan.
You're not supposed to sign Quiplash.
It was Mentos Pablo. It's a Pablo flavored Mentos.
Mentos Pablo. Well, it won 59-41.
Kind of everybody, fresh maker song now.
Everybody but Malph voted for Mentos as well. How your spouse knows you're having an affair with a clown. Did I say that right? How your spouse knows you're having an affair with a clown. You had to bail him out for scaring passersby, or when you honk her nose after blowing a load. What?
That doesn't even make sense.
How your spouse knows you're having an affair with a clown.
I kind of can't parse that.
I mean, that makes sense, actually. Right?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, no, it makes sense. Yes.
Yeah.
I voted for it.
I also voted for it. Actually, so did literally 91% of chat.
Oh my god.
Oh man. That's like a historically great Quiplash answer. If you want a really effective scarecrow, make sure it resembles a clown or Jon Snow. Ben Klee, thank you for the Twitch Prime subscription. Enjoy Tehran Day.
Harambe?
This is a bad prompt.
No, we don't do that anymore.
I don't know. This is almost a no vote for me, but
this is a bad prompt. What do you put here? Make sure it resembles what are crows scared of?
You scare nothing, Jon Snow.
So you're Ygritte or you're Jon Snow? Good. Like I could tell.
A clown wins.
Where do you rate Ygritte among the wildlings?
Short.
It's Ygritte, he says.
Is that her name?
It's Ygritte. Oh, remember, for the final stage, you may have to look at my stream to see. Sometimes you have to do a caption contest. You familiar with those if you read The New Yorker?
Isn't that, like, against, like, terms of service? Getting right, people to three, look at your stream?
Yeah, that's... Every time I tweet about watching the stream, bring it to terms of service. All right, this one is Acrolash.
Acronym.
Acrolash.
I don't know what that means.
It's the acronym.
Oh, come up with a full name for this acronym. POG.
What does it say? With stars in his eyes. Is that what the word is? The lyric?
Is that what the word is? Yeah, is it, he's a jukebox hero with stars in his eyes. And he could be a freaking jukebox hero.
Pop Jack.
Okay.
Pop Jack.
Okay, I don't even know, man. Perfect Olive Garden. Prisoner of Guar. Fucked up on gummy worms. Pretty young thing. Pussy only good. Pussies on geldings. That's gross.
What's a gelding? A young horse?
I think it's a young horse, yes.
Okay. More like a young diesling.
Pretty young thing starts with a Y.
It's a Michael Jackson reference. It's a Michael Jackson reference.
And a T.
It's a Michael Jackson reference. I thought Prisoner of Guar was pretty good.
Yeah,
oh, it's a castrated horse.
Why would they castrate a horse?
Maybe it's too fucked up on gummy worms.
Nice. Oh, seriously, why would they do that?
So it stops getting naughty and starts getting racing. You know?
Can't you do that?
The dick weighs it down.
Fucked up on gummy worms came in last.
Sorry, Ryan.
All right. Number 3, Perfect Olive Garden. Number 2, Pussy Only Good.
Give me the gold, boys.
Number 1, Prisoner of Guar. That's the end. Let's see the final
scoreboard. Ooh.
Malph wins.
Yeah.
Damn.
Oh, yeah.
I'm like 7 out of 8 on the last lashes.
He had a great answer with when you honk her nose after blowing a load.
That is really good.
Nick, you see my drawing of the Joker?
Oh, you posted it already on Twitter?
No.
That's really fast.
Yeah, that's fast. Really fast. Wait, did you do Jack Nicholson Joker?
I did.
This is the best one.
Oh no.
I did Potato Head Joker.
I like that one.
Round one.
What is this? This prompt is the dumbest thing I've ever seen in my life.
This one's really good. I hope I'm going up against Austin.
Why is that?
Because you say you didn't like it.
Okay, Jackbox has a fascination with this person, I think. Because this is the second time I've seen this person in a Jackbox game.
Is it Janowan Blamison?
Yeah. No, it's not.
You're lying! I never hit her!
I can't respond to this one because I've never seen the thing that he's been in. Damn it.
Hurry up! Use a safety. Ooh, you got 15 seconds.
Experimental tree layout on 69 right now.
Ooh, this is a draw some ginkgos.
New maps.
They're stinky.
Stinky ginkies.
Stinky ginkies.
That's what I always called them.
A get well card for someone injured by a robot. You'll be back, or at least it won't take your job. I'm just going to go ahead and say that I really like one of these.
You know what? I like both of these.
Hey, did you guys see that robot that made like 100 meals in 1 minute?
Oh, no, yeah, man.
That's a real thing.
It was probably just like a old Japanese sushi chef inside of a costume.
What were the meals? Was it like a single slice of bread on a piece of paper? Or
beef
something?
Wellington.
It was an accoutrement of a pumpkin puree.
Charcuterie platter?
Yeah.
An aperitif and a mousse bouche of charcuteries?
Oh my god.
You broke out every one of those words.
A job that doesn't exist but surely would have the highest death rate if it did. Waxing NL's head with soda water sponges or horse breeding surrogate.
No.
You'll be back one, by the way.
Yeah. This is pretty good.
Yeah, we need more people in the audience. Go to www.jackbox.tv. I don't care if you're at work, just do it and put in that code and go vote for this nonsense.
Who's at work at 7:30 p.m.? Actually, that's not that late at all.
Security guards.
Also time zones.
Yeah. Horse, 7:30 is really
horse
not really.
Breeding surrogate has won.
Hell yeah.
A great pickup line to use on the person cleaning up the spill you caused in the grocery store. That's what I get for jerking the gherkins, or there's more where that came from, BB.
Dan. Big brother.
Do you have a problem?
Was it mayo or yogurt?
Excuse me?
Or maybe it was tzatziki.
I got freaking quiplashed on That's What I Get for Jerking the Gherkins?
Honestly, that was... Yeah. That was
There's more where that came from, BB. Got all of you.
It was better. We've heard the Jerking the Gherkin one before.
You never heard There's More Where That Came From?
Well, not on Quiplash.
Something David Schwimmer probably repeats to himself every day. The Friends theme song or I Am the Best Friend, I Know It, I Am.
That is such a Ross thing.
Upper Class Walrus, thank you as well. For the resub. Dan, get out of my chat. Don't write Swimmer in there.
What?
It's a banned word on this show.
Swimmer?
We don't say swimmer here. I am the best friend. I know it. I am. 69 votes. 69%, I should say. That was, which means it was a quiplash in theory.
I've never seen Friends before. It's not fair.
Vezuez, thank you. What the inflatable arm flailing tube man did before working at car dealerships. Scarecrow or first string quarterback for the New York Jets?
Oh, I gotta vote for it.
It wasn't Robin.
I just like the burn. I don't even know anything about him, but I like the burn.
Pretty sure Dan's roasting me right now.
I think Ryan's roasting you, dude.
What makes you think I know anything about football? Ooh, another lash for Daddy.
Yeah. I knew it was you.
Ryan, shit's tragic.
74. Quiplash, first string QB for the New York Jets. Thanks for the free points.
Okay. You know what? It doesn't matter. I won the last one, so I'm retired.
A sign your marriage may be falling apart. You see ultralight memes when you see her, or when your girl fucks your best friend.
One of them is just painfully true.
What is
a lot of ultralight memes?
What is an ultralight meme?
This is a
goddamn TCM Destiny. Thank you for the Twitch Prime subscription.
Ultralight memes.
I can't believe I voted for one of these. No offense, Rob.
I mean, this is a pretty bad prompt.
I mean, you see ultralight memes when you see her. 54 to 46.
I mean, I'm not surprised, really.
Round one is in
the works. Let's see the scores. Fucking Dan.
I'm still pissed I got quiplashed.
Yeah, you're right.
You pronounce words so weirdly sometimes.
Got quiplashed. You are not one to talk off.
Quiplashed.
No.
No.
Nah, shut up.
Blab bear. Thank you as well.
Well, I think you got the prompt I got.
Thank you, Raffish Rabbit, for the 569 and GTA Badgers. I like the little cat face, too. That's nice.
Damn. No.
That
a little gerbil in the corner.
Is it named Fievel?
He was a teddy bear hamster, and I loved him.
That's ice cold, man.
What is this prompt?
What's with the XDs? Ja ja ja, XD, XD.
Yeah, it's just all nonstop XD in chat.
I actually hate that face.
What does that face represent?
You got 6 seconds left.
You hate that face?
I really, really hate
they
XD.
They named the Pokemon game after that face, and you still don't like it?
Yeah, it's the Gale of Darkness.
How you know your RV is haunted? When you ain't afraid of no bed, or when you see Negan bashing Yeezy Walt Disney.
Dan.
Wow. Austin versus Dan.
Wait, you don't. It pains me you don't know how to pronounce that name.
It's a very common one.
Yeezy.
Crispy Games, thank you.
Is it like Keegan? Negan?
Reason World Heights, Hollywood.
Apparently, no one watches The Walking Dead.
That show got shitty after the end of season one.
Yeah.
It's still won!
Yeah.
There's no justice!
Next on yeah.
Rob, you voted for it.
Of course I did.
A super elite underground club at Yale that nobody knows about.
I the love you guys, chat.
The London 2012 rowing Kenya team. Or you wouldn't know it, it lives in Canada.
That sounds like the subtitle to a horror movie.
It lives in Canada! Vacation, all I ever wanted. Chad just says Kenya will rise. That's a bad sign for me. Yeah, oh god, I got like 80%. Sorry, 70, my bad. Dan's got he's got one hand in his pocket and the other one's got his finger on the trigger.
He's got a pocket
hands
full of
in
shells.
My pockets.
A promise you shouldn't make to a sick child. I mean, I don't even want to read either of these, but I know you'll live, I feel it in my heart, or America is heading in the right direction.
Oh my god.
Where are we right now?
This is
like
What? It's just like not okay. It's a total Fievel moment.
That's the darkest thing ever.
Oh my god, America's heading in the right direction. 74%.
Well, that was not as bad as
Nixle was extremely real, and for going there, I had to give him a vote.
I knew it was you.
Only me and you voted for them.
Don't throw out those chopsticks. They can be used to hold a new set of chopsticks. Or, don't throw out those chopsticks, they can be used to pick up Asian foods like sushi.
Wow. I'm going to take the fifth on this one.
These are both.
This prompt, though.
This prompt. Yeah, yeah, see, exactly. Exactly. I'm going to guess Austin on chopsticks.
Why? I mean, Dan's is definitely not one of those. Because you could use them to train to be one of the best karate masters of all time.
To hold a new set of chopsticks.
Man who can just fly with chopsticks. Yeah.
53
anything.
To 47.
That problem was bad. It was really bad.
Austin, give me something to draw. I'm done with the Joker.
Draw a bear sitting on a futon.
And vote. The worst interrogation would have a good cop, a bad cop, and a Dan cop. Or the worst interrogation would have a good cop, a bad cop, and a drunk cop.
Drunk cop just on the ballpark opportunity, it might win. Gotta play every vote I can.
Buy low, sell high.
That's like that that famous 80s song, right?
Dan cop.
Dan cop is definitely
Dan
gonna
cop,
win.
Dan cop.
Austin just wants to ruin my quiplash.
Dan cop. Fucking won. Yeah, 68
to 32. I knew it
would. Chat, you gotta be the change you want to see in the world.
Moving on. Dan cop.
Remember, when dining at a sushi restaurant, you should never ever chug the soy sauce / go ass to mouth or kill your entire family with a 9mm Beretta.
Guys, I can't what? Any of these.
What? What? What is the first one?
What is either of these?
I mean, the first one just takes a turn that makes no sense.
The first one was like, you gotta shock people to get votes. The second one is just out of control.
Yeah.
That was Rob!
Yeah.
And it won!
You should never do that.
Oh my god.
You should never do that.
Kill your entire family with a 9mm Beretta. 52 to 48.
This guy once chugged soy sauce and he OD'd and died. And you just don't go ask him out anywhere, but don't do it in a restaurant.
I feel like you just have all these weird, strange deaths that you just have listed down somewhere that you can pull out.
I mean, I figured it kind of worked there in that situation.
This is round three.
Yeah, this is the final lash.
Make sure you're just swing up.
Man, I'm doing so bad here. I shouldn't have gotten so fucked up on gummy worms. It's a word lash.
You're really trying to bring that joke.
Dude, I thought it was pretty good. Come up with a fancy wrestling move. Sorry, a flashy wrestling move with this word in its name. None.
Who's gonna do the obvious one?
What's the obvious one?
I've been performing today, all right? Don't give me that shit. I didn't write fucking Yeezy, Kenya, all that shit.
See? When you insult those quiplashes, you insult the entire chat population minus Luke.
Stop calling him Luke.
That's his name.
Electronic Luke, that's his name, yeah.
I'm gonna give mine like a 4 out of 10.
Yep.
Yeah, I hate mine that I'm about to press enter on.
But I tried,
alright? You
got 10
seconds.
I tried. Oh, fuck. Oh, I had a better one in my head.
It was a foul.
It was a foul. Responses. Pick your medal winners now. The desiccated nun. The nun cracker. The South Africa nun buster. The nunder down under. None yo business, my business, Luda!
Oh, man.
The Nunya Stunner. Grim Reaper 003, thank you as well.
I'm going Nunder Down Under.
Yeah. The Nunder Down Under.
Luda.
Whatever happened to Luda?
He's still killing it.
Where is Ja?
He's in the Fast and the Furious movies, making like quadrillion dollars.
Is he really? He's still. Is it the same character as he was in?
No, he plays his evil twin now.
You know, I would actually believe that.
Plays Din Diesel.
That's like David
Luda's gonna win, isn't it?
It's better. Yeah, Luda. If Luda finishes in the top three, this stream's canceled.
Luda wins.
Top three, boys.
Oh, it's looking like it has a shot at the top three.
Oh, no.
Austin is going to win another last lash. I'm amazed. Desiccated Nun. Nunya Stunner. South Africa Nun Buster.
Is top three.
Nun Yo Business. The Nun Cracker. And the Nunder Down Under.
All right, that's it. Come on, boys. Hang out there.
Did it, boys. Top three.
He's trying to keep the streak alive.
Oh god, Austin won. Thank god. He stopped Dan from taking the victory.
Click here to share your favorite quips. God, I went from first to fourth out of that.
Yeah.
Man, last lash is really way more important now.
Freaking Austin wins it every time.
I won it last time.
Yeah. Oh, god damn it.
He won the lash. You won the game.
Oh, you mean the last lash, not the whole thing.
Yeah, he's like a shootout winner, guaranteed. If you make it to OT, he's potting that shit behind any goalie in the NHL.
Don't say overtime to me right now. I'm triggered. You don't get it, but I'm triggered if you say overtime.
It's like a football thing.
No, I played Rocket League with people and we've lost roughly 30 overtime games in a row or something like that. This is awful.
I don't know what that word. What the fuck is that? What the fuck? Oh wait, this is too good.
Alright, we're good.
I really want to do this.
You got 37 seconds left.
That's alright, I'm done already.
37 seconds left.
You know what, I did it. I don't even care, really. It's alright, it can lose. I'll take the loss.
How much time?
I'll take the L. Hashtag take the L.
How much time?
No time. You're out of
37
time.
37 seconds.
That was close.
All right, let's get to it. First off, the most awesome thing to say after getting fired from a sperm bank.
The most awesome thing to say after getting fired from the sperm bank. I faked it every time. Or I'm going to work at the horse pussy factory.
I really like I faked it every time, actually.
It makes just enough not sense to
me. Yeah, it's really good.
Filled all the bags with mayonnaise.
I was thinking about trying to work some like Hellman into this. But I was like, how do I make that actually connect?
Yeah.
Oh. Sorry, Malfi.
No.
64-36 and a quiplash.
Oh.
Wow, I actually put Malf on. I faked it every time. That's a very Malf answer.
It is. A procedure that not even the slimiest. A procedure that not even the slimiest plastic surgeon will do. Dolphioplasty. So is that when you turn into a dolphin, or they turn you into Dolph Lundgren?
Dolph Lundgren.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
Dolph
yeah.
Lundgren. One.
Or. Replace your dick with a horse dick.
Well, someone would do it.
Thank you.
I'm sure it's probably already happened at this point.
Come on.
No, it hasn't.
Nobody out there is walking around with a horse's dick where their dick used to be. That is
no,
ridiculous.
Sure it's happened at this point.
We all hope.
Ooh, replace your dick with a horse dick. Fan favorite, 57-43.
Hell yeah, it is. Thank you, Shainer84, for the subscription. Raise your horse emotes and eggplants, please.
Oh, no. The next big craze for yuppies. Bottled soda water flavored by Bling Egg Water. Or bottled LaCroix.
Oh my god.
It's pronounced lacrosse.
It's actually pronounced LaCroix, as much as I hate to admit it.
It's actually pronounced LaCroix.
It should be LaCroix.
Leroy.
Hey, Leroy. Le quoi? Le quoi? Le quoi? Le quoi? Une mousse bouche, une haute cuisine?
Say mise en place.
Mise en scène.
Mise en scène.
I want to come in. Last Grey Wolf has just subscribed on Twitch Prime. Thank you. Really appreciate it.
With Twitch Prime?
Yeah. The only Twitch Prime.
This is
51 to 49 for LaCroix.
Oh,
what about
so
the
close,
chat?
Dan.
Make a relationship work. Chat betrayed you, Dan. Why Wolverine can't make a relationship work? He's Canadian, or he smells like shit all the time. Consider my bush unamused.
I like that one.
Why does he smell like shit all the time?
He smells really bad. I mean, he's never rolling really outside. You're always watching him, but
working on motorcycle shit and like rolling in the dirt.
Yeah, that's probably true.
Cutting up trees.
Cutting up trees.
Covered in blood.
Is he Canadian?
Yeah. Yes. Oh, how do you not know this?
I don't know. I
fucking tree lover.
I made the answer, and it won 81-19, and I still didn't know if it was true.
Oh, it's your disappointment, Ryan. I just no.
Stimlam Blamiston. Thank you. I didn't get the newsletter. A sign you may be in a cult. You vote for answers because they have Dan. You watch Ultimate Chicken Horse while listening to Bono. Yo, Dan, if your answer is you vote for answers because they have Dan, you've redeemed yourself fully in my eyes.
That is, I voted for it.
If you've become fully self-aware and parlayed that into a lash here. I know Hugh Jackman's Australian, come on. Oh, it's a mouth answer.
It almost said laugh.
And
wipe out.
Mouth's answer won 90-10. And he got a super quiplash. I've never seen that.
That exists?
I got an achievement. Thanks, Mouthy.
You're welcome.
A bad way to start your valedictorian speech would be, ladies and gentlemen, I killed my entire family with a 9mm Beretta. Or, ladies and gentlemen, I am the warrior. Or, I am the warrior. Dan, you can recover from that super quiplash, man.
I'm not feeling the love.
I've turned the cult against him.
I agree. I think the callback makes this one work.
Yeah, you think so?
Yeah, so did chat.
It's like more dangerous without my samurai sword.
It's like 86%.
I draw the line. We can talk about dead animals, we can't talk about dead Cairo Cedro. That's right. He's dead.
He died.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's dead. No,
you didn't know him. You didn't feed him little seeds out of your
about?
Hand.
I knew him. I Skyped with him.
I wish that were true, but I just can't believe it.
Oh my god, that's so true. Someone in chat just said, actually, if you voted for the cult answer, you're in the cult.
This doesn't even make any sense.
Exactly.
Ryan, what do you want me to draw?
Draw your favorite Canadian.
Austin, your drawing's done.
Oh, tweet it at me.
I have no fucking idea. Oh, this is like such a bad answer. I'm gonna type it in anyway. Okay, whatever.
Is this either gonna do really well or really bad?
That might be the dumbest answer.
I think I also went double down on dumbness and maybe rocketed out the other side into the funniest prompt of all time.
I hope so, because I think I just hit the bottom. I didn't pop back out.
Ozymandias, thank you as well.
Both of mine are pretty bad.
A job you'd really be or you'd be surprised requires a urine test. Pot smoker or touring tester?
What's Turing?
It's the Alan Turing test to tell if, basically, if you can tell you're talking to a computer AI or not. So,
if one of us were to take that, would we pass it?
Yes.
Well, it's.
I hope.
Yeah, yeah. You're really supposed to.
Oh, I accidentally no-voted, but that wasn't because I didn't like the answers. It's just because.
Mouth, have you been smoking?
All day, every day. It's 4:20, ain't it?
57.
No, dude, and even if I was, I couldn't admit that on the internet.
That's true.
Canadian.
It's not legal here.
Yeah, it is. It's not.
It's for my glaucoma.
The best way to make a waiter at a snooty restaurant angry is to keep asking for your goddamn amuse-bouche or les trois ans.
Oh, goddamn. Fucking just kill me now.
Excuse me, do you have any Grey Poupon? Les trois ans.
Les trois ans.
Nick, it's okay. For your goddamn amuse-bouche actually won. Thank
what?
You.
What? I'm surprised.
What about chat? What did chat vote for?
Chat voted for the Moose Boosh, man.
No!
We barely moved the needle. Like, this is all chat. A weird Tom Hanks / Meg Ryan movie. Sleepless in Starbucks or Sleepless in Sao Paulo?
I guess it kind of sounds like Seattle. Yeah. Sao
Paulo. You should have written Sleepless in Sao Paulo.
Yeah, that would ensure a win.
Rue Lazar, thank you.
The Seagirl to Brazil.
The Seagirl?
It's the Seagirl to Brazil.
Rob, sounds like you got rid of the Diglets, man. Congrats.
Yeah, no, it'll happen eventually.
Ooh, Sleepless in Starbucks. 63
it's funny
to 37.
Caffeinated beverages.
You guys have any 24-hour Starbuckses near you?
Literally all of New York, yeah.
Breaking news! Scientists have just discovered nature's fiercest creature. The really fierce shark or Swedish pizza shark?
Oh.
Oh, that laugh. That just like little Dan laugh.
The really fierce shark or Swedish pizza shark?
Here we go.
Did blue team just give up? What happened here?
I think they did. Are you team 6 or team 9, chat?
Oh, people are having chat problems, I guess.
Ooh, really fierce shark.
Wow.
55 chat? To 45. No.
We've come out on the other side
I'm
of the
losing
memes.
The electoral vote. No, Wednesday. I won the electoral vote, but not the
podcast. Wednesday, the November the 2nd goes down as the day the Dan... fell from grace.
A terrible thing to announce on your first day in jail. Your mother's a terrible cook, or I'm open for business.
You should have said, I killed my entire family with a 9mm per.
Medium rare ribeye steak closed for business. Meatless ribeye steak open for business.
That guy's got like a pretty active YouTube channel, actually.
He's found a niche, that's for sure.
What's that? I missed this one.
It's a guy, he's extremely vegan, and he sings songs about how he wants to eat your vagina if you're vegan. But if you eat meat, you're never gonna get his tongue on your puss. I'm open for business. Really, it won 85 to 15 there.
Wow.
Ouch. What the S stands for in Ulysses S. Grant? S plus or succotash?
You know what? That's a real good word.
This is soup, right?
I think it's just a vegetable, isn't it?
It's corn and lima beans.
Oh.
So what am I trying to say here? It's like a slaw?
Yeah.
Or well, like no, it's not.
It's a hash?
I don't know.
Maybe it's a stew.
It's okay. No. Wikipedia says succotash like is a food dish. So there you go. That's what
it's like
is.
The consistency of like grits.
Okay. Succotash.
Have you had succotash,
well.
Nick?
Wow.
I think so.
I don't know why when Dan says it, it feels weird.
What, oh wait, is it? Tash? No, it might just be. It might just be not cut up, actually.
No, it's not. Yeah, it's
suck
just straight up.
Tash? I don't know what it is. You're saying it right, but it's getting me. Getting me in the sweet spot.
I'm thinking of something else.
All right, is a word lash.
Oh, did you know that combining a grain with a legume provides a dish that is high in all essential amino acids?
Come up with a new TV show that has this word in the title. Kill. No jinxes.
It'd be funny if there was a jinx on mine.
I think if yours is what I think it is, there could be.
I mean, mine's... Well, did you just straight up go for the most obvious possible one?
Maybe. You had 25 seconds left.
I wonder if anyone's going to put kill my family with a 9mm.
Oh, a 9mm, what though?
I don't know.
Messed up, Chuck, 55, that's messed up.
That part's up to you to figure out.
All right, we're ready.
If someone has kill Ghost Bill, now. They probably win.
Kill the new NLSS chat, I want the old Kanye. I killed my whole family with a 9mm Beretta. The death of Pablo, kill.
That's not mine, don't.
Kill the bagel boy. Kill or no kill, kill Phil.
Why?
Yeah. Yeah.
It says Pablo, and you're saying it's not yours, Dan?
It's not. It's Melf impersonating me.
No, it's not. I don't need to do that.
Pablo. It's not even three Pablos, it's four.
It's four
the
Pablos.
The true people know my answer. The true.
Do you guys believe Dan would put four Pablos?
I think he might.
No, Dan's the I want the old Kanye.
Okay, everyone, let's see who got those.
Alright, let's see these votes.
First, the bronze.
Oh! Austin's streak is about all to right, end, I think.
Oh!
Last place. Kill the bagel boy. The death of Pablo. Kill Phil. Kill the new NLSS chat. Kill or Nick. No kill. And then, in first place, I killed my whole family with a 9mm Beretta.
Nick, you stole my beams!
I was playing mind games! I thought if I made an answer that sounded like Dan's, everyone would vote for it.
Alright, one more.
Come on, you don't think that strategy wasn't that bad?
No, it was a good strategy.
That's pretty good, because I didn't think you would do that, Nick. That's a Melf move.
Top answer?
Not.
Top answer, you vote for the answers because they have Dan in them. That's from Melf.
Thank you. Come again.
It's time for Quiplash.
You guys know that I killed my entire family with a 9mm friend.
It's the worst thing that's ever become a meme on the show.
It probably is, actually, yeah. Well, outside of Cairo Sage Bros.
Yeah, that was. We went maybe a little too far on that day. That's because, in true internet fashion, I was skeptical of the news article until I actually saw it. And then I was like, oh, we're too far to come back.
Yeah, but if you read the article, it sounds like a meme itself.
I don't think so, dude.
Well, he's going overboard yelling. What did he yell?
No, come on, you can't laugh if it's real.
I believe like... he shouted no.
Come on, Dan.
I used to be able to make Nick uncomfortable. Now he's so used to it, doesn't he?
That's not okay. It's really sad. Yeah, I agree.
All right, when apathy kills 6v9, it's the saddest shit of all time. It's like an occasional box showing up and there's like 200 people in here. I've learned a great lesson not to not commentate 69 ever again.
Can we get a Kappa check in chat, please?
Actually, you know
yo! Just because he was hanging out with a 16-year-old doesn't mean there was any weird shit going on. It's not a crime to hang out with a 16-year-old.
Wait, duh, but sure. See, when I read the article, I pictured it being like the end of Titanic. With him.
Damn.
Stop. Damn. I can't not laugh at that.
Damn. Okay, you got six seconds. You got 3 seconds. You got 2 and 1.
I feel like
and
he went out on his own terms. Like, that's how he wanted to go out.
Putting us in a difficult situation in whether or not to
you
laugh.
You think he wanted to drown?
Okay, well, he was training. Right. He was training an apprentice. That's why and things went wrong.
It was too soon.
The sound a black hole makes. The sound of shooting about 3 hot dogs. Or Murph me!
More like mouth me.
If young Mouthy don't trust you.
Oh no!
This one's going viral.
The greatest hot dog shooter.
Dan, have you seen the greatest hot dog shooter in the Northwest?
That guy is Dan.
No, I saw it on the subreddit, but I didn't click it.
Dude, go watch it right now. Take the next 45 seconds off from the stream. Go watch that video.
That's seriously Dan with like a headband. Or bandana, whatever.
It's nothing like Dan.
No, it is. Dewey in
his will. What is Scrooge McDuck? What is Scrooge McDuck going to give Dewey in his will? Censored pics of his duck hole. No answer from Austin.
Wait, why is he looking at a hot dog? Good name for a
team. Is Austin here?
No, hey Austin, if you're a wiener, don't say anything.
I got him!
A good name for a roller derby team composed of nuns. The Nunchucks or the Cairo Sageros.
Oh, check Discord.
We're gonna go viral with this one.
okay, yeah, no worries.
Oh, God.
Too soon, Dan.
Is he really inhaling them?
He's getting obviously some
of them. I really
thought
you were gonna say, is he really in heaven?
No, he's inhaling the hot dogs.
Yeah, he's just doing it.
Some of them don't come back up, man. Do the math. And one of them, he sucks down 5 hot dogs. Only 3 of them come up.
Yeah, I told you. He stopped to have a lunch break.
I really want to know where they went.
The Nunchucks wins.
Yes.
A bad name for a proctologist. Dr. Feels Bad Man or Dr. SARS.
What?
One of these, like, at least kind of makes sense.
No, they don't!
Like, because he's feeling up your butthole, and he's like, it feels bad, man.
That's the one that makes sense to you?
Yeah. It's a play on Dr. Feels Good.
Okay. Dr. Feels Badman?
It just feels went too far.
Badminton.
Hot dogs.
I could go for some hot dogs right now.
I can't believe Dr. SARS got so fucked.
What are you talking about? I said hot dog.
SARS only...
He's gonna be a hot dog shooter. Dennis the Menace grew up and he got the new nickname Dennis the fucking asshole or Dennis the criminal.
Dan, what do you take in your coffee?
A little bit of almond milk, just a pinch.
Really?
Almond what? Yeah.
Almond what?
That's the most almond surprising milk. Thing that I've ever
I forgot
milk?
To tell
almond
you.
Milk.
I was at McDonald's like a week ago. And, you know, Fox, they have those kiosks now.
Oh, yeah.
First off, that's just an aside. But you go to the kiosk, you get your receipt, and then they call you up when your food's ready. The order before mine, they were like, okay, number 1126, 1126. And fucking asshole one, by the way. They never, nobody came up and claimed it. So they're like, 1126, large coffee, 8 sugars.
What?
That's too many sugars for one coffee, dog.
That's a lot of sugars.
This guy in the general store used to come in. He's like this weird taxi driver. He'd get 5 milk, 5 sugar, and that was the most. And I thought,
oh, God. Austin didn't put in an answer, so a good slogan if you're running for president. Dan gets a quiplash with Make America Hood Milk Again.
There it is.
Diglett's voice!
Oh.
Spam the Diglett's.
My coworker chat. Takes 15 sugars?
No, I don't believe
that's
that.
That's not right. Even. That's you can't even problem. Dissolve that in the coffee. Like, that's beyond the saturation like, point of the coffee.
There's no way that that is true.
Oh, here we go. New York style.
Sit up.
Dan, can you say pumpkin scrubs, boys?
For who?
For Kate.
For Kate, yeah.
It's Kate in chat.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, after I just gotta come up with some answers for Kate here.
Yeah, yeah.
A 15 sugars, man.
I might have dated myself with that answer, actually.
What is this question? This is so stupid.
I used to take 20 Splendas until my friend refused to go with me through the drive-thru out of embarrassment.
That's a real-life intervention.
I feel like three is okay.
Splenda is disgusting.
If I went through the drive-thru with somebody and they're like, yeah, I got a large coffee, 3 cream, 3 sugar, 3 milk, 3 sugar, I'd be like, okay. No problem. If you get up into 4 range, you gotta like give him a look like, you alright, buddy? If they get into the double digits, you have to be like, this is actually a problem. You have 4 seconds left, by the way.
Oh, fuck!
At that point, you're like, what's
you got
this?
In. You got in.
Men in black.
You
got in. I got in. Sugar it worked. Water.
All right, hey, guys. Yeah. Guys, what happened to Austin?
He's dead.
He had to go, but he's fine, I think.
Yeah, just read the Discord. Dan Arena.
The perfect thing to yell to make a peewee basketball player miss a free throw. You're gonna miss, jackass, 100%. Last gray wolf can't be bothered.
God damn.
It's alright, I had a good answer anyway.
To be authentic, New York style pizza has to have lots and lots of handballs or no answer because Austin's not here, so.
Alright. Moving on.
What a rich jerk drinks champagne out of? Beyonce's burger hole or a recession glass made of ostriches?
What's a recession glass?
What?
What is a recession? Back during the recession, nobody could afford glasses, so if you had
parents
glass,
started buying their kids razor blades.
All right, you know, because of your description, I'm voting for Beyonce's burger hole.
What's a burger hole?
I didn't. It wasn't my answer. I was just trying to find the logic in it.
What is a recession glass, Dan?
What is recession glass?
Like, people used to drink out of their hands in the recession, so if you had a glass, you were well to do.
Why don't you let Dan answer? I want to hear Dan say.
I googled it and it says depression glass.
What should never be followed by an exclamation mark? Scrapple? Or, and then one is just an exclamation mark with a smiley face after it.
What's Scrapple?
I hate. That's it. I hate this. I just hate.
Scrapple's like corned beef and like potatoes.
What? It's a thing?
Didn't we talk, like Josh told us about Scrapple?
No, that's succotash.
Scrapple? Is that like?
Scrapple, also known by the Pennsylvania Dutch name of Panhas or Pan Rabbit.
Oh, a nice breed of conies. Boil up
that in your recession glass and drink it.
Well,
when a check goes, a recession glass isn't even a real thing.
Malvez won with the smiley face.
I thought that I was gonna lose, to be honest. I had no idea what to put.
The
no
real
idea.
Reason the giant was trying to kill Jack because right it there? Turned out he wasn't jolly or green. Or he killed his whole family with a 9mm Beretta.
Stop voting for that. I don't want to perpetuate that. Somebody's going to come up to one of us and say that thinking it's a meme, and we're going to be like, what the fuck? Get away!
Rob's going to fight him, and I'm going to call the cops.
Yeah, exactly. Perfect, yeah.
Rob or Rob's Diglett?
That won't be funny if that ever happens.
I even thought about writing that in that one.
The meme can't be stopped, boys.
Yeah.
80% Beretta.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you, Ryan.
Come on.
I almost jinxed you on that.
Steamer
I was so
had
close,
a
I was
whiplash
like,
prompt.
You know, every once in a while, Ryan says, you know, he's got honor, but honestly, he's got no honor.
You know you're old when you're at a bar and the bartender asks you, what dinosaurs thought about the dis? Or, how many sugars in your hood milk?
No.
Oh, God damn it.
It's like Michael what Scott. Dinosaurs? Every morning he drinks milk and sugar.
What dinosaurs thought about the deaths?
Deaths? I'm voting for it.
This is supposed to be the Declaration of Independence.
Oh.
Yeah. But I had no time left.
I would have preferred not to know what it
meant. Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
How many sugars in your hood milk? 78 to 22.
Let's go, boys. We're back.
So, by the way, Scrapple is traditionally a, this is how it's actually described, a mush of pork scraps and trimmings.
Ooh.
Combined with cornmeal and wheat flour.
I'll take the supersize, please. Extra pork scraps in mine.
It looks so gross!
Wait, have any of you guys ever had pork rinds before?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, you gotta look at the stream, like... it's a comic lash.
The... I don't like them.
Comic lash. It's
like eagles again, isn't it?
It's like...
Comic
They're
lash.
Like fluffier Cheetos that taste like, you know, sweaty underwear.
Ghost cheese.
You don't like the taste of sweaty underwear?
Taste the ghost cheese?
You guys see the...
This is awful too! Yeah, they're all bad. Bad!
This guy and me have the same body hair pattern.
Chet's like, oh no!
Yeah, here we go. No Berettas.
Come up with a quiplash that has this word in it. Beretta. You got 20 seconds.
Can we have a six-way jinx?
No, Austin will win because he's got no answer. You got Austin 8 seconds.
There's people putting the gun emoji in Ryan's chat saying Beretta boys.
This is out of control.
I stand with Nick on this.
You can't have a letter as a Twitch emote, but you can have a fucking gun. Hand out those guns now. I killed my whole family with a 69mm Beretta. Nice. I killed my entire family with a 9mm Beretta. Petted a kitten riding down a landslide. OD a guy with sugar milk. Asked Ryan Letourneau, it's not even spelled right, why he walks on his toes.
Yo, I've got videos of Ryan walking on his toes. I will release them if I get...
You sound like a weird, like, smut peddler.
Are you a smut peddler?
I got videos of Ryan walking on his toes.
From high school, no less. No.
That's barely legal, boys.
I know.
I hate all these. I'm only giving out one vote, and it's a sugar milk.
Oh, shit.
The sugar milk?
Yep, sugar milk gets it.
Wow.
Fuck all y'all.
You can't say fuck it. You're the one who used it twice.
I used it 3 times, actually.
Oh, my God.
Anything for a win.
Ooh, Austin's in last. Then kitten in a landslide. Then OD a guy with sugar milk. Then 9mm. Then 69mm. Then ass. My name is spelled wrong. Why he walks on his toes? Let's see the final scores. I hope he's still lost. I can. Yeah. Okay. You're far enough behind. Whatever. Who cares? Ooh. Daddy wins again.
Oh my God.
Come take the crown if you want it. Mouth with the top answer again, though.
You can't stop me, man.
With the nunchucks.
Thanks for not letting me down, Chet.
Let's take some time to pimp our channels. Why don't we start with Dan?
Why always me first?
It's the last person to join gets the first pimping.
All right. Hey, guys. It's Dan. Some of you guys know me. I play a lot of Star Citizen on YouTube.com/DanGiesling, and I also make subtle references to make fun of Ryan. Throughout some episodes. But yeah, youtube.com/DanGiesling. I'm streaming after this. Thank you guys for having me. And never forget about Cairo.
Beautiful.
Jesus.
I mean, that's honorable.
Cairo will rise.
How about you, Melfi?
Why, that's Michael A. Fox on YouTube and Twitter and Twitch is where you could find me for stuff. YouTube is good. I'm about to build some conveyor belts in my RimWorld, so that's pretty exciting. Maybe you want to check that out.
How about you, Robert?
Yeah, hi, I'm Rob, also known as Alpaca Patrol. You can find me at Alpaca Patrol everywhere, Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube. YouTube Civ 6 Ultimate Chicken Horse, Twitch Poke Month, pretty
You're
much
just saying
day.
Words.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's kind of what forming sentences is.
Oh,
but,
now he puts together like a complete
words
sentence.
And letters.
And then also on Monday, I'm gonna launch my first T-shirt, so I'm excited. I'm gonna pop my T-shirt cherry.
Dope. How about you, Malfi?
I'm
just joking.
Yeah.
Nick's turn. Got him.
No, it's Malf's turn. You go, Malf.
No, it's Nick's turn.
Got him. My team.
Thanks for watching Northern Line Live Super Show. It is. Nick.
Oh my god. Hey everybody, Rockley Smile. Check me out at youtube.com/RockleySmile, over on Twitter at RockleySmile, and here on twitch.tv/RockleySmile. Thank you for everybody that followed, donated, and subscribed and watched today. We will be doing some Owlboy, I think will probably be the next thing, as well as a few other indie games that have come in under the radar, and I might even end up with a copy or a demo of Agony, which I'm very excited to be able to play. So feel free to follow if you haven't already, and I'll see you on the next one.
More like agony.
Got him!
Got him!
Jesus, he got me.
Tell me.
Got him!
Hey, everybody.
What about Austin?
Thanks. Hey, I'm Austin. I stream at Twitch.tv.
Hey, I'm Austin. Dog.
Hey, guys, I'm Austin.
Coin, you sucker.
I stream every day at 1 p.m.
That's actually wrong, too. He streams at 2.
Ryan, can you do a Mathis real quick before you send us out?
Oh, hey. Didn't see you there.
Pumpkin scrubs, boys.
Pumpkin scrubs, boys.
Hey, peeps. Hey, peeps. Look at my shirt.
That's my impression of anybody. Here's my impression of, like, Barack Obama. I'm Barack Obama, the President of the United States.
I'm Barack Obama.
That was almost mouth territory.
I'm Barack Obama. I like that. That's good.
It's like Honey Bunny doing that.
I mean, like, all right.
I'm John C. Reilly. And
that's really good.
Oh, come on.
That's really good. Do it again.
Well, I don't really know what to say.
Dude, you got it. Were you practicing in the interim
period?
No,
actually I wasn't. But you know what? Now that I got it the first time, I could do that one at least. Now I have to work on it, making it actually good.
He's got it spot on now. It's like the protein in your body was like, we need to build some different like structures in your larynx. And then they did it over the past 2 days.
I think he's been practicing in the mirror all night.
Yeah, no.
Next time I see you, if you've got right like now. A fucking forehead line that I could swipe a credit card through and curly ass hair, I'm going to know what happened. Anyway, NLSS airs every Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday. You can see it again tomorrow at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. We'll see you then. For now, this will host up a little Dan Giesling for, I don't know, you playing Star Citizen?
Yeah, but I'm going to leave up the drawing that I made of you.
All right, that's fine. That's very flattering, as you said I'm your favorite Canadian.
That's not too many Canadians worth...
All right, well, see you next time.
It's not like I care.